Also, secure, private, and confidential. The data is not shared. Spam Assassin. It is enabled. Multi-channels. Mail channels. Amazing stuff. Mail channels are protected. Also includes squirrel mail. Webmail access. Horde webmail access. That is important. And you know, if you're an email person, you know that Horde webmail access is absolutely, absolutely incredible. Round cube webmail access. That's right. Also POP, SMTP, IMAP, and SSL access. Unlimited storage, email trace tool as well. User managed, you can do filters, forwards, autoresponders, auto inbox cleaning, and vacation toggle. Plus Box Trapper Config. What this means is your settings, your messages, your white list, your ignore list, your black lists, your forward list, and your log and your queue all at your disposal. The social networks are involved also. Unlimited free auctions. Think about that. That's fantastic. Also unlimited free bidding. Free recruiter services along with free freelancer services. And there's not a lot of places that do that. So that is absolutely incredible. Free classifieds as well. Full feature blogging. Groups. Brainstorming. Map sharing. Map of members worldwide. Event management and video and photo sharing as well. Also a lot of other things that I don't want to talk about here on the radio. I don't want to give it away. Go check it out over there at cool-post.com/LITE. Smartphone community as well. Extended access, blogs, groups, profiles, microblogging as well. File sharing and page publishing. Bookmark sharing as well. You can join up at cool-post.com/LITE. No parent company ads, no enforced format passwords, no forced password resets, no enforced logins, and no lockouts without a dialogue. You can check it out today at cool-post.com/LITE. Affiliate opportunities as well. Every user is included on this one. They're not going to just let certain users in there. Everybody is included. Multi-level payouts, level on each of 50 levels, random setups as well, bonus resources, and optional white labeling. And that is big, as everybody knows, in the profit share world. Optional white labeling, absolutely, absolutely amazing. Daily withdrawals to a PayPal and daily withdrawals to Pay2. And of course, we all know about Pay2. Pay2 is PAYTOO. Check that out when you get a chance. They do that over there at cool-post.com/LITE. Reliable mail service. Safe and social networking as well. Amazing profit shares. These guys are they're one of our big marketing partners, and this is one of the reasons why, is because they always help people out. They do payments by PayPal, MasterCard, Visa, Maestro, American Express. They have it all over there at cool-post.com/LITE. That's the website. You want to check it out today. It's cool-post.com/LITE. And we're back with more here on the program in just a few moments.
Caribbean teaching in medical education. I lived on two different islands, and I taught behavioral science and ethics. Currently, I teach counseling, so I am a social science, behavioral science guy.
Well, that's fantastic. Now, Russell, let's talk a little bit about liberty education and libertarian philosophy, because, of course, professor at Emporia State University, previously worked, as you mentioned, in the Caribbean. Give us your background here on this liberty education and libertarian philosophy. Break it down for us.
Sure. I came over to libertarianism from the left. I was a lifelong registered Democrat and voted almost strictly party line. Then I started exploring the philosophy behind each political ideology, and I realized that I was much more aligned with the libertarian philosophy than either the left or the right. And in my own journey towards educating myself about libertarianism, I've had the opportunity to write a piece for the Libertarian newsletter weekly, biweekly, under the moniker of Professor Liberty. It's helped facilitate my own education. And I got to tell you, the more I personally learn about the Party of Liberty and libertarianism, small L and large L, the more I am convinced that it is the most ethical, moral, and effective political ideology.
Okay, explain that a little bit to us, because I know there's going to be a lot of people in our audience that are going to be like, huh? kind of break that down for us a little bit more, my friend.
Sure. Let's take ethics for a moment. I believe for a political doctrine or ideology or belief, as a cognitive scientist, I would look at this under the scope of belief. For it to be sound and legitimate, it must be moral. Otherwise, however effective it is, if it is not moral, it is illegitimate, and we should discard it. I believe that libertarianism aligns with solid, logical, reasonable meta-ethics and normative ethics. Let me take the five pillars of ethics, as we would say. The first is autonomy. Autonomy is self-rule, self-governance, self-determination. If that doesn't speak of the party that believes in the primacy of the individual, libertarianism, I'm not sure what does, right? Another pillar is beneficence, which is to promote well-being and to do good. This is great, along with the third pillar, non-maleficence, do no harm, fidelity, promise-keeping, and loyalty. And finally, justice, which is equality. I would place autonomy as the foundational pillar, as the most prima facie binding of those five, because if the individual cannot be free to make his or her own choices, then in order to establish everything from justice or to promote well-being, it comes by way of intrusion and coercion.
Okay.
And that simply is not ethical in my estimation.
Well, I'll tell you, you've got a great background here as far as coming over from the liberal side to the libertarian side and everything. It's fantastic. Tell us a little bit about what you see as far as the philosophy is concerned, as far as libertarianism, because I know that, for instance, with the conservatives and the Republicans, they say they're a certain thing in their philosophy, but they're not. And the Democrats say that they're a certain thing in their philosophy, and they're not. Explain libertarian philosophy, and is it the same as the talking points, basically?
Sure. Granted, I could and probably should, and had we more time, establish and expand more on my philosophy.
Yeah.
In terms of the ethics and the moral philosophy. But if we take that as a presuppositional given, that it is legitimate, then we move up into more applied ethics and philosophy, such as you're referring to. I like to say that I came over to libertarianism. More, I like to say I came up to libertarianism.
Okay.
Many people view, as you know, politics on the spectrum, the left and the right.
Yeah.
And many of us libertarians would believe that politics exists more on a grid. And over to the left are the liberals, contemporary liberals, even though libertarians might categorize themselves as classical liberals. Over on the right are the conservatives. Down below are status, and up above are us libertarians.
Yes, yes, indeed.
The philosophy is maximizing individual liberty, which means the government should allot to the greatest extent possible social and economic freedoms.
We've got Russell Fulmer with us today, joining us here on Skype. He's our Libertarian Party focus this week here on the program. And he's joining us today via Skype, and we got him on the line today to discuss libertarian issues and liberty education and libertarian philosophy. is his libertarian focus. He's currently a professor at Emporia State University. He's with us today talking about everything to do with the libertarians. Now, the Libertarian Convention is coming up very soon. One of the heavy hitters, Gary Johnson, is going to be at this convention. Tell us a little bit about his impact on the last presidential election from your standpoint, my friend.
Sure. Well, needless to say, probably, but I voted for Mr. Johnson. I am looking forward to meeting him. I'm hoping to be able to meet him and even conduct, ideally, a small interview with him as part of my human rights committee work in terms of what I do. I think he's had a good impact. He's a nice figurehead. He puts himself out there. He's appeared on everything from The Daily Show with Jon Stewart to various and sundry other programs. And it is the hope of myself and others in the party that he can take us to the next plateau and we can increase our enrollment and numbers and get more of the populace to vote libertarian and establish us as a solid and viable third party. We already are, but we want to just take it even further, of course.
Yeah. Yeah, we've got Russell Fulmer with us today. He's our Libertarian Party focus here on the big broadcast, and he's currently a professor at Emporia State University. Previously, he worked in the Caribbean in medical education. He is our Libertarian focus today. He's been focusing here on libertarian liberty education and libertarian philosophy, and he's joining us today here on the old Skype-a-Rooney. And I'll tell you, my friend, it seems to me that the Libertarian Party seems to be gaining a lot of momentum as things go forward. I guess as we wrap up here with you, my friend, where do you see Libertarian Party as a whole and even here in Kansas in these midterm elections and even into the presidential election here in a few years?
I am an optimist. I see us in a good position and moving forward. We have outstanding leadership at the state level. And they are doing their best and doing a quite effective job at taking libertarianism to the next step, and increasing our, just putting the word out and getting more voters. I think part of that is my small role, and I would encourage your listeners, you, everyone, to do the same who believes in the party message, to educate others and get the word out. It's astounding to me how many folks either are not familiar with libertarianism or have an incorrect definition of libertarianism. It's amazing the number of people who confuse libertarians with liberals. And so my approach, my philosophical approach, is not the most pragmatic when you're speaking with people. They might not care, to be honest, but at least simple things such as, what is a basic definition of libertarianism? How do libertarians differentiate themselves from the Democrats and the Republicans? What is in it for them? People are driven by self-interest. In a libertarian world with libertarian politicians, what would they get? How would things be different, and how would that be of their best interest? Those are the types of things that we can do when we converse with the populace to advertise, so to speak, the party and the principles that we believe in.
We've got Russell Fulmer with us today. As we wrap up here with you, Russell, how do we connect with you online, my friend?
I am a dinosaur of sorts. I do not have a social networking presence as of now. I am happy to converse over Skype or email. I'm easy enough to get a hold of if people choose. You can also contact me via the party in one way, shape, or form.
Well, I'll tell you, my friend, are you going to be at the Libertarian Convention? I know we're going to be broadcasting live and doing some interviews. I hope to meet you in person and be able to chat with you for our radio program when you're out there.
I hope to meet you as well, sir. And yes, I do.
Sir, who walked in behind me? Good Lord. Well, Russell, have yourself a wonderful day. We'll talk soon, my friend. Thank you much.
You as well. Take care.
Definitely. Have yourself a wonderful day, my friend. And that is Russell Fulmer. We are going to take a timeout. We've got more when we get back.
Millie and Cupcake. That's right. Cowcow.com/Millie and Cupcake. Also, check out cafepress.com/Millie and Cupcake, the number one. Also, Millie and Cupcake is available on Amazon. You can purchase the book through our link at JiggyJaguar.com. Millie and Cupcake available in paperback. Also available for Kindle. It's a story of a girl and her wonderful pet. For many children, the experience of bonding with and loving a first pet is an unforgettable time in their lives. Millie and Cupcake is the charming and educational story of a girl and her companion animal, a different animal than many kids think of when choosing a pet. Check out Millie and Cupcake on Amazon right now. Millie and Cupcake also is available on the web at cowcow.com/Millie and Cupcake. Also cafepress.com/Millie and Cupcake, number one. Tell them you heard about it here on the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show. Let me tell you about search engine optimization that is performance-based. It is SEOgame.com. Visit them online and see the difference. SEOgame puts in over 30 hours of work to start keyword phrase search engine optimization services without a setup fee. Cool? Yeah, it's very cool. If you don't like your results, you can opt out at any time before 30 days without paying a dime. At the end of 30 days, your first payment is due and you get billed monthly thereafter. Five keyword plans begin at $200 a week. 30 keyword plans begin at $500. If you want your business to grow, you need to get SEO game performance based. SEO. Go to the website right now, SEOgame.com. That's SEOgame.com. It's a new year here at the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show, and we are ramping up for a tremendous, tremendous 2014. We have a lot of things coming up this year. We're doing a lot of television projects, going to be doing a lot of radio as well, and we need your help. Shop our Amazon.com links. You can do all of your shopping through our website at JiggyJaguar.com. That's JiggyJaguar.com. It's as simple as clicking on our Amazon link. That will take you to Amazon. Amazon will still look the same. It'll still feel the same. You'll still get the same deals. We just get a little bit of help off a commission from Amazon if you do shopping through our link. Also, we have our advertising available on Fiverr.com, as well as many of these other micro sites around the internet. We have a complete list at our website, JiggyJaguar.com. Recently, we had Dr. Ted Baer on the program talking advertising with us.
If they said that our media doesn't have any influence, why would somebody buy an ad? Why would somebody buy an ad on your program? Hey, we don't have any impact. There's no reason for you to... So it's a no-brainer.
So check it out right now. We've got everything available at JiggyJaguar.com. Thanks for listening and thanks for supporting Transmedia Worldwide.
Techno-mall.com. Over 2 million homes are burglarized in America each year. Remove your risk of burglary with secure, remote, invisible locks. Without a lock to pick, burglars will struggle to find a way into your home or your business. You can even secure your windows and glass entryways as well. Check out techno-mall.com for more information. Techno-mall.com.
Okay, folks, let's talk about self-development, wealth creation, renewal, and rejuvenation. Are you stuck in a rut? Do you aspire to be something bigger, something better? Well, author Y.E. Shavola has penned two incredible books that will help guide you down a new path, a path that will lead towards self-development, wealth creation, renewal, and rejuvenation. Learn how to make your dreams a reality. You owe it to yourself and your loved ones. Y.E. Shavola's books are available on Amazon right now. How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Self-Development, and How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Wealth Creation. Get them at our website through our Amazon link at JiggyJaguar.com. Find them on Amazon. Check out Y.E. Shavola's incredible books, How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Self-Development, and How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Wealth Creation. Today on Amazon.
Back to the Jiggy Jaguar Show on the network.
Well. It is the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show, coast to coast and border to border, all over the World Wide Web and on 50 plus stations throughout the U.S. and Canada. It is a fabulous, fabulous Thursday. And I'll tell you, we have one of my good, close, personal, longtime friends, a guy who really knows his stuff. Larry Pratt's going to be with us here in just a few moments. Gunowners.org is the website. And Larry is one of these patriots out there that you just can't ignore. His personality and everything just takes over the room. And that's why we love having Larry on every once in a while here on the program. And if you want to join us live, you can do that on the TuneIn apps and Radio Loyalty and on 50-plus stations throughout the U.S. and Canada. Today, we are live 2 to 5 Central, 3 to 6 Eastern, and 12 to 3 Pacific. And we're 24-7 at JiggyJaguar.com. Larry Pratt is on the telephone. Larry, welcome back to the program, sir. How are you?
Well, it's good to be back. Thanks so much.
Now, I'll tell you, this Piers Morgan thing is absolutely hilarious. I am so shocked that it took this long to get this guy off the air. Everybody in the brothers has been talking about it, from Alex Jones to me to everybody else. What is the deal with Piers Morgan? Did he quit CNN or did he get fired?
Well, he claims he's still at CNN. Now, I don't know whether that means he's in charge of the broom closet or he's going to do the 3 a.m. show. But in all honesty, I wish him no ill. We had so much money come in after his behavior when I was on his show.
Yeah.
He crashed our server 3 times. We now affectionately refer to that pot of gold as the Piers Morgan Memorial Endowment Fund. He doesn't have a clue, but even worse perhaps from his point of view is the fact that it was the robustification, if you will, of our email list,
yeah,
produced by his behavior, that enabled us to defeat the Toomey Mansion bill. And here's how it happened. We were getting where we knew the vote was coming, and we hadn't heard anything from the NRA, and we thought, well, you know, they're probably having trouble because they invented the background check. It's their bad, and they had trouble, we were assuming, figuring out how they were going to be against it, an extension of it. So, okay, we put out an email saying, if you are also a member of the NRA, would you please send make a phone call to this guy at this number at the NRA and ask him to try to get the NRA to come out publicly and score as an anti-gun vote anybody that votes for Toomey Mansion. A week later, that's what happened. Now, the rest of the story, as Paul Harvey used to say, almost simultaneously with their public announcement that they were going to be doing the right thing, we heard Senator Manchin squealing like a stuck pig. What are you guys doing? This is a betrayal. You've done a 180. They were working sub rosa for Toomey Manchin. And they did a 180 in a week after we had our guys beat up on whoever that poor guy was at the NRA. So now you know how that bill was stopped. It is just delicious because I don't think our previous email list, which was not even quite a third of what it is now, would have been enough punch to do it. But obviously what Piers Morgan gave us, the Piers Morgan Memorial email list, was sufficient to do it. So we have a, you know, kind of a fondness of in a way for Piers Morgan, and maybe someday we can go get him to insult us some more. His basic problem, I think, is he didn't realize that you don't tell a bunch of Yanks that they got their revolution wrong and tell us with a British accent.
That too. And I think CNN was attempting, they thought what would happen is they have a lot of different programming, like on Sunday mornings, they very, very early, they have some different programming from all over the globe. They have various different programming of that nature. And I thought what they thought was, well, we'll get this guy on. He'll appeal to a worldwide audience, and America's Got Talent. He was a judge on there, and all these things. But what they didn't realize is that the UK didn't want him back. And we didn't want him.
You're familiar with those White House petitions that if they get I think it's 100,000 signers, then that triggers a White House committee to providing some kind of response.
Some sort of response,
It's sort of like if you like your policy, you can keep it. That kind of promise, I think.
Yes.
Well, one of those White House petitions then was started by a Brit and saying, No, we don't want him back. It took us 40 years to get rid of him.
Well, Larry, we've got Larry Pratt with us today here on the big broadcast, Coast to Coast and Border to Border, gunowners.org, if you want to get more information, or you can call 888-886-GUNS. Or you can visit gunowners.org. And Larry Pratt joins us. He joins us every once in a while to talk about gun owners issues.
And folks go to gunowners.org. They can sign up for our action alerts, and that's the very tool that we use to kill the bill.
Wow. That is fantastic that you guys can mobilize people. That's the thing that I find absolutely amazing, is that in the era of social media and all this craziness, a simple email list can still mobilize people. So you've got a heck of a deal there, my friend.
We know how to when people sign up, they give us their not only their name and their email, but their address. And we use that address and the full, 9-digit zip to determine what is their congressional district. So even if that little puppy runs right down the middle of the street, we'll know which side of the street they're on from their zip code, and we'll be able to assign their email to the proper member of Congress. And that's why you're not just sending an email, and generally we don't think it's a good idea to have the whole country send Congressman Schmo an email, because if you're not going to be able to vote for or against him, what does he care?
Yeah.
Now, maybe if it's John Boehner or Mitch McConnell, that's a little bit different, because they, in a way, are hearing from the people they represent in the Congress, and they do a little bit more care what people around the country are thinking. But generally, it's a targeted deal, and so these guys know that if I got all these many people with an email upset at me, then maybe I'd better pull my horns in.
Well, I tell you, it is absolutely fantastic. We have got to take a little bit of a break here with Larry. When we come back, we're going to chat about some different gun owners' stories and this revolution, this uprising that is forming around the country. And we talked a little bit about this earlier this week, but we're going to get into it a little bit more with Larry when we come back here on the big broadcast, Coast to Coast and Border to Border.
Are you out of work? Are you looking to make a lot of money on the internet from the comfort of your home? I have consistently made over $30,000 every month for the past 8 years. I have received daily $900 payments, $1,800 payments, $3,000 payments, and even $10,000 payments. It's fun, it's easy, and beginners are desperately needed right now. Sign up today at www.pcmteambuilder.com/CouponJoe and make potentially $30,000 a month, just like I did. Again, the website address is www.pcmteambuilder.com/CouponJoe.
Dear friends, please take a moment to make a difference. They need our help. www.pathelpingpeoplefoundationinc.com. That's PATHELPING PeopleFoundationInc.com. They have to raise some money to continue their services and help to provide to those in need. $10. It may not seem like much to change someone's life today. It may not change the world, but it will help make a difference to change someone's world. Please make a pledge, friends, to help support this organization, as we so often do for other organizations, and please help And please, friends, pass the word on to your Facebook, Twitter, Glide, YouTube, WhatsApp, Pinterest friends as well, in support of this organization. Thank you, and may God bless. That's www.pathelpingpeoplefoundationinc.com. Listeners ask us all the time, how can we support the operation? Head over to our website at www.jiggyjaguar.com. That's right, jiggyjaguar.com. Click on the Amazon banner on our page. It will take you to Amazon. You will still see all the great prices, all the great selection, all the great convenience. But when you shop Amazon, we get a little bit of a credit from Amazon, and it helps us keep the operation going here. Recently, we had best-selling author, National Award winner Dan Perkinson, and he was talking about Amazon.
I listened to your promotion for Amazon.com. You can buy book one and book two, which just came out.
Look at that.
I encourage your listeners to go there and support your operation.
You don't need to buy anything you don't want or need. Just do what you do on Amazon. Buy everything you usually buy there, but do it through our link at jiggyjaguar.com. We get a small percentage, as I mentioned earlier, and it helps really fund our operation. Thanks to our friends at Amazon.com, and thanks for you for supporting us, the great listeners of the world-famous Jiggy Jaguar Radio Broadcast.
What can Plexus do for you? It isn't a secret that being overweight has become a worldwide epidemic. In addition to normal concerns of clothes not fitting, lack of energy, and low self-esteem, being overweight can lead to dramatic increases in diabetes, heart disease, cancer, stroke, arthritis, and depression. Consider the following. 8 out of 10 Americans over the age of 25 are overweight. 174 million Americans are overweight or obese. Then worldwide numbers are just crazy. They're expected to double by 2030. 25.8 million children and adults in the United States have diabetes as well. If you're like millions of others, you've probably tried this diet or that pill, but you never got the results you wanted. In fact, the Centers for Disease Control reports that 95% of all diets and weight loss programs fail. Finally, there's an all-natural, healthy solution to help you lose weight. Originally made for diabetics, Plexus Slim is now available. PlexusPinkDrinkHealth.com. People around the country are experiencing amazing results, and you can too. It's www.PlexusPinkDrinkHealth.com.
How many of you would like to make an extra $21,000 in the next 21 days? Call 678-318-1896 right now for all the details. How many of you would like to receive cash daily to your doorstep? Call 678-318-1896 right now for all the details. What if you had a turnkey system that did all the sorting, sifting, and selling for you? Call 678-318-1896 right now for all the details.
Back to the Jiggy Jaguar Show on the network.
Welcome back to the broadcast. Our podcast is available each and every day over there at JiggyJaguar.com. You can also get more information on our radio program 24/7 stream is available on TuneIn and Radio Loyalty. We've got Larry Pratt joining us for a second segment here. And Larry, there is a, I guess you would describe it as an uprising. Tell us a little bit about this. I know we've talked about it here and there through the week, but I know you've got the most accurate and updated information on this.
Well, I got so excited about what a fellow was telling me, lives in Connecticut, yesterday, that I ended up recording this week's show with him as my guest. He lives in Connecticut. By the way, the show's, you can get it simulcast at gunowners.org, and it's they're a little behind posting right now, but eventually they'll get it, I think, and you can listen to it on demand at that point. But the nub of it is Walter Reddy is a guy that had trouble in the state. He was out shoveling snow in April of 2011. So that tells you a little bit about what it's like to live in New England. And all of a sudden, there's maybe 20 cops of a multi-agency task force surrounding him. One puts a gun to his head and marches him inside. Where's the shotgun?
And wow.
Gives him the shotgun. What had happened is that he'd had a friend over some time before. I guess I should put the word friend in quotes. And he'd shown the guy his shotgun. He had other guns. But he'd shown him the shotgun. For whatever reason, they were talking about the shotgun. And that was what the cops came looking for. They entered his house, gun on him, no warrant presented. Totally illegal. They grabbed the gun, take the gun. I guess it was the local constabulary that kept it. And he tried to... he wasn't able to get a lawyer in time for the initial hearing, and he asked that it be put back. And they played all kinds of, I don't want to go into all the legal games.
But yeah.
Eventually, after spending some $10,000, Gun Owners of America helped him raise some of that money because we've gotten money from our members precisely for that purpose as well. He eventually got the gun back simply because the statute ran. A year went by. They didn't have ever any charges against him. He had a hearing. And at the hearing, somebody was describing the shotgun as a street sweeper when it was a standard Remington type, you know. There was a police officer that clearly was lying on the stand. And so, you know, the judge said nothing here. But they still wouldn't give the gun back until the year had run. All right. That kind of ticked him off, you know. And so I think that was probably sometime into 2012. His state senator, a female rhino, and for those that are not familiar with the term, Republican in name only, you know, people like Mitch McConnell, John Boehner.
Exactly.
She, as a rhino, had voted with the Democrats to require the registration of these terrible semi-automatic rifles. And... also known as assault weapons, incorrectly, I might add. Anyway, he's now announced his campaign in the primary against her. And he said most, I don't remember if he said all or most, but most of the, let's be safe, most of the rhinos are also getting primary opponents. And in a poll that was taken, the guy that's the likely Republican nominee for governor is literally neck and neck with the incumbent Democrat governor. Now, if this is happening in Connecticut, what must it be like elsewhere in the country? Hoo-wee!
Exactly, exactly. We've got Larry Pratt with us today. Gunowners.org is the official website. Go over there and get more information on what some of the different topics me and Larry are batting around today. What do you make of this situation? We reported a little bit of it the other day about that Bloomberg and the crew are trying to backdoor and snatch the guns in the New York area.
Well, by the grace of God, we whooped them in New Hampshire. He went up there and he said, this is what we want. And I think there was a package of maybe three bills. Anyway, they've all been defeated. So if Bloomberg, in a state with a Democrat governor, can't pull that off, then I'm not sure. And if Connecticut has turned against him. Oh, and the rest of the story in Connecticut, it's estimated that maybe upwards of 200 or more thousand people have decided, I ain't registering my gun. That's not constitutional.
Yeah.
Put 200,000 people in jail?
Well, see, this, yeah.
If you try confiscating those guns, you know what's almost certain to happen at some point, and that won't be pretty, and it might be called the shot that was heard around the world the next time. Only this shot will be somewhere in Connecticut rather than in Lexington, Massachusetts.
Well,
if you get what I mean.
Oh, I hear you. Oh, I hear you, Larry. This is a crazy, crazy situation with all the they're trying to take the guns, and that's always the first step in any type of regime. They got to get the guns away first.
It's indicative of the ruling class mentality. They think they were born to rule, and therefore you and I were born to do whatever they tell us.
Yep.
And you know, that rubbed Americans the wrong way the first time, and they're still trying to use a guy to hector us with a British accent. And I think, if anything, he helped stir things up more than they might have already been stirred up. Consider that in Colorado last year, there were two recall elections involving two senators, Democrats,
yep.
who had all voted in lockstep to do all kinds of a package of anti-gun measures.
Yeah.
Those two state senators were defeated. One was the state Senate president, and the other was the chairman of the committee who had very arrogantly cut off any opposition voice, which was very untraditional in Colorado. They would take several days, if need be, to hear everybody that said they wanted to have a say.
Yeah.
Well, they didn't then. So the in the recall election where these two Democrats both went down, the one, Angela Giron, the committee chairman,
yeah.
Was defeated by as many points in the election as she had a registration advantage in the district, 11. Imagine that. What a swing.
Wow.
What should have been a rather safe Democrat district had to have had Democrats voting against her. And I think what we might conclude from that is there still are Reagan Democrats. They don't see any reason why they should become Republicans. I mean, look what the Republicans do, Mitch McConnell, John Boehner. But
yeah.
when you have an issue, which all too often Republicans try to obscure in an election, and I'm a nice guy and blah, 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 but this one was all about guns and arrows.
Exactly, yep.
She went down, and the Republican that was on a separate ballot wasn't running against her in the event that the seat opens up. Would you like to have this Republican or this Democrat replace Chiron? Well, turns out the Republican won. And so he didn't even have the advantage of running against her baggage. It's just that people were really ticked off, and they wanted to send a message. I don't know if the message has been delivered yet when you see Bloomberg running around. And by the way, he gave enormous resources in that election to the Democrats. The Republican candidate and the opposition, those supporting the recall, were enormously outspent. One of the recall elections
oh, yeah.
was headed up by an unemployed tradesman.
Okay.
Not exactly a political pro. It was just one of us that was really annoyed and decided he was going to send him a message. And I thought he sent a pretty good message. I don't know if anybody's listening, but...
Well, you know, it only takes one a lot of times there, Larry. Yeah,
one guy with a lot of determination, and kudos to the guy because, he had to go out and get umpteen thousand petitions signed.
Yes.
Signing on petitions, and that's a fairly straightforward thing to do, but it's a bloody lot of work. And
yes.
Maybe
yes.
because he was unemployed in President Zero's economy.
I love that. President Zero. I love that. Well,
call his legislation Zero Care?
Pretty much. That would be the gimmick, I think, that we could go with there, Larry. I love that. Well, Larry Pratt's been our guest. Gunowners.org is the official website. And, Larry, thanks for doing this. Thanks for coming on every once in a while and chatting with us. I do appreciate it. You're one of my favorite guys. And
well, thank you. I appreciate your microphone. And what did I hear when the show... during the show, something like 50-plus stations.
That's right. That's right. We're getting it going, man. We're the little engine that could out there on AM, FM, and internet. So
excellent.
It's fantastic.
Good news.
Well, Larry, have yourself a wonderful day, and we'll talk soon.
Looking forward to it.
Appreciate it. Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye.
Larry Pratt with us today from gunowners.org. If you want to get more information on what we're up to, you can do so over there at jiggyjaguar.com. And fantastic stuff. Larry Pratt with us today. And he is doing some amazing things with gunowners.org. So if you get a chance, you want to head over there, get on their email list. And really good patriot things are going on over there. We are going to take a time out. When we come back, Frank Savalto from the New Media Journal on the way. Dear friends, please take a moment to make a difference. They need our help. www.pathelpingpeoplefoundationinc.com. That's P-A-T-H-E-L-P-I-N-G, peoplefoundationinc.com. They have to raise some money to continue their services and help to provide to those in need. $10. It may not seem like much to change someone's life today. It may not change the world, but it will help make a difference to change someone's world. Please make a pledge, friends, to help support this organization, as we so often do for other organizations, and please help. And please, friends, pass the word on to your Facebook, Twitter, Glide, YouTube, WhatsApp, Pinterest friends as well, in support of this organization. Thank you, and may God bless. That's www.pathelpingpeoplefoundationinc.com.
Attention, everyone. Is your computer getting slow? Are errors popping up all over the screen? You need QuickSpeed PC. Get your free scan today at quickspeedpc.com and speed your computer up like new. That's quickspeedpc.com for your free scan today. Go to quickspeedpc.com today. quickspeedpc.com.
The response to our Amazon shopping has been amazing. You guys have come through in a record amount of traffic by shopping our Amazon link at JiggyJaguar.com. Every time you buy your books, electronics, videos on demand, smartphones, netbooks, Kindles, everything, you can even buy groceries over there. That is absolutely amazing. When you shop our Amazon.com link at JiggyJaguar.com, that's JiggyJaguar.com, we get a percentage of the sales from Amazon. So every time you buy your HDTVs and MP3s. Recently, Dan Perkins, best-selling author, had this to say about Amazon.
I listened to your promotion for Amazon.com. You can buy book one and book two, which just came out.
Look at that.
I encourage your listeners to go there and support your operation.
So keep shopping our Amazon link at JiggyJaguar.com. Every time you do your shopping, we get a percentage of the sales, and that's boosting our operation here. We couldn't do it without you, and the response has been phenomenal.
Somewhere over the rainbow lies a pot of gold that's sure to make your next fundraising event a huge success. Rainbow Dust, the innovative and exciting project that is a must-have for any fundraiser, is the hottest interactive candy product on the market today. Visit www.myrainbowdust.com to see how Rainbow Dust can add magic to your next function. Find out why kids will be standing in line for their turn at making their own delicious Rainbow Dust candy creation. Use the promo code RADIO2 to receive free ground shipping. MyRainbowDust.com. Let the magic begin.
Okay, folks, let's talk about self-development, wealth creation, renewal, and rejuvenation. Are you stuck in a rut? Do you aspire to be something bigger, something better? Well, author Y.E. Shavola has penned two incredible books that will help guide you down a new path, a path that will lead towards self-development, wealth creation, renewal, and rejuvenation. Learn how to make your dreams a reality. You owe it to yourself and your loved ones. Y.E. Shavola's books are available on Amazon right now. How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Self-Development, and How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Wealth Creation. Get them at our website through our Amazon link at JIGGYJAGUAR.com. Find them on Amazon. Check out Y.E. Shavola's incredible books, How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Self-Development, and How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Wealth Creation. Today on Amazon.
Talk with Jiggy right now at 1-866-763-1242 and email JiggyJaguar@JiggyJaguar.com.
It is the world-famous Jiggy Jaguar Show, coast-to-coast, to border-to-border, all over the World Wide Web, and on 50-plus stations throughout the U.S. and Canada. Thanks for tuning in to the big broadcast from the KJAG Radio Studios in Hutchinson, Kansas. We're live Monday through Friday, 2 to 5 Central, 3 to 6 Eastern, and 12 to 3 Pacific. And we're 24-7 at JiggyJaguar.com on the TuneIn apps and radio loyalty. And our podcast is available over there at JiggyJaguar.com. And, hell of a day. I had a fantastic lunch meeting, I guess, or dinner meeting. What would you call that? I don't know what you'd call that. You'd call it something. I just don't know what you'd call it. What's that voice? I don't know. I'm checking us out on the old Ustream. I'm trying to get the Larry Pratt video up on our on our YouTube channel, plus do a whole bunch of other crap that I should have done during the break. But coming up, we're going to be chatting with Frank Savalto. I think we're going to be chatting with him in the next hour, because I don't see him. We usually call him on the old Skype-a-Rooney, but he is he's not showing up, so I think that he might be next hour. I don't know. Frank recently moved into a new time zone, so we are trying to get him confirmed, because I think he was in Florida at one time, but he was having some issues, and so he moved to somewhere that's Mountain Standard Time. So I'm trying to figure out when we chat with him. We're also going to be chatting with Shannon Rose, Hollywood Rose Report, because of course it is Thursday. So we will chat with him, and of course there will be some professional wrestling news when I talk to Shannon. I've been going to ask Shannon at some point if he knows the Midwest Mangler, but I don't think that he... I know that the Mangler says he knows Shannon, but I don't think Shannon knows him. I think it's more of a case of he's like, who? It doesn't matter. Like I said, last evening had a very successful dinner engagement, I guess you would call it. That might be the best way to say it. I don't know. KJAG Radio is going to be doing some amazing things very soon. So you just might want to stay in touch and stay with the program and see what we do. Watch us work, I guess, or something. Is that that's the WSU slogan? Watch us work. 52 minutes after the hour, when we come back in our next hour, we're going to be chatting with someone in Australia. So I'm going to attempt to dial the international telephone code. I don't like that. I don't like that crap. But he doesn't have Skype, so we pretty much have to do that this way. But quick little programming alert. I will not be here next Friday. It is the 14th. It is St. Patrick's Day. It's not because I'm taking the day off for St. Patrick's Day. It's the fact that I will be taping an episode of the CW, the KSCW show that is taking place. And we're going to be promoting our Consoles for a Cause event, which is going to be taking place in a couple weeks. That is going to be a fantastic event. So it's going to be fun. It is going to be a fun deal. We're going to be helping out the Sterling Autism folks, so that should be a blast as well. And get more information on our little nonprofit over there, Concerts for a Cause. Concerts for the Cause. Right? It's my nonprofit, but I don't even know what the freaking deal is. It's concertsforthecause.com. That's it. I don't know. I'm an idiot half the time. You know this. We're going to be hopefully announcing our new flagship station very soon. I don't know. I've been communicating back and forth with these folks. I think, personally, what's going to happen is I don't think we're going to end up over there. I think they're pulling some shenanigans on us. Honestly. I think they're pulling some shenanigans on us, but I don't know. If you want to get a hold of us over there, you can do so at JiggyJaguar.com. Now, Fukushima birth defects in Yakima, Washington. Well, we have time for this story before we head to our top of the hour. Large number of babies being born without brains in Yakima, Washington. This comes from BeforeIt'sNews.com. There has been a steep increase in the number of babies born without brains in the area surrounding Yakima, Washington. And all trends of this sort have a reason. Through radiation, though radiation is not the best mutagenic agent, it's the only viable and variable that could be causing this. The Yakima region of Washington got the brunt of the American fallout from Rector 3, and since that is an obvious causative variable, I'm going to say that this recent rash of birth defects in Yakima region have their cause rooted. Of course, controlled opposition sites are going to blame whatever else they can shift the blame away from Israel. But if you have been looking for the big picture and not a stupid lie, it's clearly posted at jimstonefreelance.com. That's jimstonefreelance.com. And, it's going to be an interesting deal with this nuclear fallout. I don't know. I think we're going to have a lot of issues with that over the next several years, and that's just not going to be fun. That's all I got to say on that. 56 minutes after the hour, we're going to take a timeout. When we come back, we're going to be talking about an ex-CIA pilot who's given sworn testimony that no planes hit the Twin Towers on 9/11. We're going to talk about all this 9/11 stuff when we come back here on the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show. Welcome back to the world-famous Jiggy Jaguar Show, coast-to-coast, border-to-border, all over the World Wide Web. We've got a fantastic, fantastic marketing partner I want to tell you about right now. It is the website cool-post.com/LITE. You need to go there right now. Check these guys out. They are simply, simply amazing. cool-post.com/LITE. These guys have been in the business for a heck of a long time. They know what they're talking about. And multi-mail channels,
they've got that. Box Trapper. You need to check out Box Trapper. I cannot say anything more. Box Trapper is absolutely amazing. It also allows the user to decide what spam slash junk and allow full access to their incoming mail queue and their own whitelist, ignore list, blacklist. By the way, absolutely, absolutely amazing stuff. The multi-channels on this, just amazing stuff. Mail channels, these guys have got it all. You need to go over and check out cool-post.com/LITE. And I want to give you a little bit more information on what these guys are doing. They've got email service, your own host, your own choice of domain. It's absolutely amazing. Also secure, private, and confidential. The data is not shared. Spam Assassin. It is enabled. Multi-channels, mail channels, amazing stuff. Mail channels are protected. Also includes squirrel mail, webmail access, horde webmail access. That is important. And you know, if you're an email person, you know that horde webmail access is absolutely, absolutely incredible. Round cube webmail access. That's right. Also pop. SMTP, IMAP, and SSL access. Unlimited storage, email trace tool as well. User managed, you can do filters, forwards, autoresponders, auto inbox cleaning, and vacation toggle. Plus Box Trapper config. What this means is your settings, your messages, your whitelist, your ignore list, your blacklists, your forward list, and your log and your queue all at your disposal. The social networks are involved also. Unlimited free auctions. Think about that. That's fantastic. Also, unlimited free bidding. Free recruiter services along with free freelancer services. And there's not a lot of places that do that. So that is absolutely incredible. Free classifieds as well. Full feature blogging. Groups. Brainstorming. Map sharing. Map of members worldwide. Event management, and video and photo sharing as well. Also, a lot of other things that I don't want to talk about here on the radio. I don't want to give it away. Go check it out over there at cool-post.com/LITE. Smartphone community as well. Extended access, blogs, groups, profiles, microblogging as well. File sharing and page publishing. Bookmark sharing as well. You can join up at cool-post.com/LITE. No parent company ads, no enforced format passwords, no forced password resets, no enforced logins, and no lockouts without a dialogue. You can check it out today at cool-post.com/LITE. Affiliate opportunities as well. Every user is included on this one. They're not going to just let certain users in there. Everybody is included. Multi-level payouts, level on each of 50 levels, random setups as well, bonus resources, and optional white labeling. And that is big, as everybody knows, in the profit share world. Optional white labeling, absolutely, absolutely amazing. Daily withdrawals to a PayPal and daily withdrawals to Pay2. And, of course, we all know about Pay2. Pay2 is P-A-Y-T-O-O. Check that out when you get a chance. They do that over there at cool-post.com/LITE. Reliable mail service. Safe and social networking as well. Amazing profit shares. These guys are one of our big marketing partners, and this is one of the reasons why, is because they always help people out. They do payments by PayPal, MasterCard, Visa, Maestro, American Express. They have it all over there at cool-post.com/LITE. That's the website. You want to check it out today. It's cool-post.com/LITE. And we're back with more here on the program in just a few moments. Millie and Cupcake. That's right. cowcow.com/Millie and Cupcake. Also, check out cafepress.com/Millie and Cupcake, the number one. Also, Millie and Cupcake is available on Amazon. You can purchase the book through our link at jiggyjaguar.com. Millie and Cupcake, available in paperback. Also available for Kindle. It's a story of a girl and her wonderful pet. For many children, the experience of bonding with and loving a first pet is an unforgettable time in their lives. Millie and Cupcake is the charming and educational story of a girl and her companion animal, a different animal than many kids think of when choosing a pet. Check out Millie and Cupcake on Amazon right now. Millie and Cupcake also is available on the web at cowcow.com/Millie and Cupcake. Also, cafepress.com/Millie and Cupcake, number one. Tell them you heard about it here on the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show. Let me tell you about search engine optimization that is performance-based. It is SEOgame.com. Visit them online and see the difference. SEOgame puts in over 30 hours of work to start keyword phrase search engine optimization services without a setup fee. Cool? Yeah, it's very cool. If you don't like your results, you can opt out at any time before 30 days without paying a dime. At the end of 30 days, your first payment is due and you get billed monthly thereafter. Five keyword plans begin at $200 a week. 30 keyword plans begin at $500. If you want your business to grow, you need to get SEO game performance based. SEO. Go to the website right now, SEOgame.com. That's SEOgame.com.
The response has been overwhelming, and we thank you guys for shopping the Amazon link at JiggyJaguar.com. Check it out today at JiggyJaguar.com. Recently, we spoke to another guest on our radio program, and he had this to say about Amazon.
I know you guys work with Amazon a lot. It's
yes.
The number one mouthwash on Amazon.
We're not asking you to buy anything you don't want or need. You know you're going to do your shopping at Amazon. You might as well help out the broadcast at the same time. To help out our operation, check out JiggyJaguar.com. That's JiggyJaguar.com, and thanks for supporting the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show.
Techno-Mall.com. Over 2 million homes are burglarized in America each year. Remove your risk of burglary with secure, remote, invisible locks. Without a lock to pick, burglars will struggle to find a way into your home or your business. You can even secure your windows and glass entryways as well. Check out techno-mall.com for more information. Techno-mall.com.
Okay, folks, let's talk about self-development, wealth creation, renewal, and rejuvenation. Are you stuck in a rut? Do you aspire to be something bigger, something better? Well, author Y.E. Shavola has penned two incredible books that will help guide you down a new path, a path that will lead towards self-development, wealth creation, renewal, and rejuvenation. Learn how to make your dreams a reality. You owe it to yourself and your loved ones. Y.E. Shavola's books are available on Amazon right now. How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Self-Development, and How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Wealth Creation. Get them at our website through our Amazon link at JiggyJaguar.com. Find them on Amazon. Check out Y.E. Shavola's incredible books, How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Self-Development, and How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Wealth Creation. Today on Amazon.
Jiggy Jaguar, the 2008 Community Access Television Rookie of the Year, and the Jiggy Jaguar Radio Show on the network and JiggyJaguar.com.
Apparently Donald Trump believes that Jimmy Carter is dead. Well, according to the Associated Press, Donald Trump is, apparently this is just making it all over Twitter. CPAC, CPAC has got Donald Trump. There's a political event. And apparently Donald Trump believes that Jimmy Carter is dead, or he's taking a pot shot at Jimmy Carter. I don't know what it was, but that's what's going on the old Twitter. However, it is hour number 2, 8 minutes after the hour. Thanks for joining us. Thanks for tuning in to the Jiggy Jaguar radio program. From the KJAG Radio Studios in Hutchinson, Kansas, we are live Monday through Friday, 2 to 5 Central, 3 to 6 Eastern, and 12 to 3 Pacific, and we're 24/7 at JiggyJaguar.com on the TuneIn apps and radio loyalty. As I drop my pen, and our podcast is available at JiggyJaguar.com. Oh, and hey, one good thing about dropping my pen, I can pick it up because I've got my my headphone extender thing. Jiggy Jaguar radio broadcast brought to you by our good friends over there at JordansJuice.com. Juice it up with Jordans. Find them online at JordansJuice.com. Jordans Juice barbecue sauce is damn good stuff, so check it out today. Let's look at this. The ex-CIA pilot gives sworn testimony that no planes hit the Twin Towers. This comes from the TAP blog, I believe. It's via, before it's news, the TAP blog is a collective of like-minded researchers and writers who have joined forces to distribute information and voice opinions avoided by the world's media. And I believe it's the-tap.blogspot.com. Another blogspot address. I should say that. My buddy Cotolo still does. CotoloChronicles.blogspot.com. But former CIA and civilian pilot has sworn an affidavit stating that no planes flew into the Twin Towers, as it would have been physically impossible. John Lear, the son of Learjet inventor Bill Lear, has given his expert evidence that it would have been physically impossible for Boeing 767s like flights AA-11 and UA-175 to have hit the Twin Towers on 9/11, particularly when flown by inexperienced pilots. No Boeing 677 airliners hit the Twin Towers, as fraudulently alleged by the government, media, NIST, and its contractors, he stated in an affidavit. Such crashes did not occur because they are physically impossible, as depicted for the following reasons. In the case of UAL-175, going into the South Tower, a real Boeing 767 would have begun telescoping when the nose hit the 14-inch steel columns, which are 39 inches on center. The vertical and horizontal tail would have instantaneously separated from the aircraft, hit the steel box columns, and fallen to the ground. The engines, when impacting the steel columns, would have maintained their general shape and either fallen to the ground or been recovered in the debris or of the collapsed building. No Boeing 767 could attain, think about this, could attain a speed of 540 miles an hour at 1,000 feet above sea level. Parasite drag doubles with velocity and parasite power cubes with velocity. The fan portion of the engine is not designed to accept volume of dense air at the altitude and speed, and the piece of alleged external fuselage containing three or four window cutouts is inconsistent with an airplane that hit a 14-inch steel box column. In March 2007, Reynolds, a former chief economist under the George W. Bush administration, filed a request for correction with the U.S. National Institute of Science and Technology, citing that his belief that the real commercial jets, Boeings, did not hit the WTC towers, although the 9/11 Truth Movement initially rejected the no-planes theory as too outlandish, and after scientific and rational analysis, it has become a widely accepted explanation of the evidence collected. You can get more information at the-tap.blogspot.com. Apparently, he is a member of pilotfor911truth.org, which has consistently shown that it was impossible for jetliners to have hit the Twin Towers in the way that the 9/11 Commission has suggested. Here's the deal. If they didn't hit the towers, where the hell's the planes? That's my question. If the planes did not hit the towers, where are the planes? It's like Amelia Earhart. Where's the plane at? Where's she at? Where's these planes at? Bottom line, you lose me a little bit when you start talking about, no planes hit the towers. How'd they come down? I understand that they're gonna, the 9/11 guys are going to be like, well, bombs. Bombs in the building, blew up the buildings. That's fine. I get that. I'm not one of these guys that doesn't think 9/11 was an inside job. I think with a lot of the bullshit that has happened, there's a little bit of evidence. There's a little bit of evidence there. But still, where are the fucking planes? Where are the planes? That is my attitude through the whole deal. But that is that. We're going to take a smidgen of a timeout. When we come back, we are going to have more. Coming up, we're going to try to make an attempt to call Australia and have on a guest. So we'll be back after this.
Are you out of work? Are you looking to make a lot of money on the internet from the comfort of your home? I have consistently made over $30,000 every month for the past 8 years. I have received daily $900 payments, $1,800 payments, $3,000 payments, and even $10,000 payments. It's fun, it's easy, and beginners are desperately needed right now. Sign up today at www.pcmteambuilder.com/CouponJoe and make potentially $30,000 a month just like I did. Again, the website address is www.pcmteambuilder.com/CouponJoe.
Dear friends, please take a moment to make a difference. They need our help. www.pathelpingpeoplefoundationinc.com. That's PATHELPING PeopleFoundationINC.com. They have to raise some money to continue their services and help to provide to those in need. $10. It may not seem like much to change someone's life today. It may not change the world, but it will help make a difference to change someone's world. Please make a pledge, friends, to help support this organization, as we so often do for other organizations, and please help. And please, friends, pass the word on to your Facebook, Twitter, Glide, YouTube, WhatsApp, Pinterest friends as well, in support of this organization. Thank you, and may God bless. That's www.pathelpingpeoplefoundationinc.com.
It's a new year here at the world-famous Jiggy Jaguar Show, and we are ramping up for a tremendous, tremendous 2014. We have a lot of things coming up this year. We're doing a lot of television projects, going to be doing a lot of radio as well, and we need your help. Shop our Amazon.com links. You can do all of your shopping through our website at JiggyJaguar.com. That's JiggyJaguar.com. It's as simple as clicking on our Amazon link. That will take you to Amazon. Amazon will still look the same. It'll still feel the same. You'll still get the same deals. We just get a little bit of help off a commission from Amazon if you do shopping through our link. Also, we have our advertising available on Fiverr.com, as well as many of these other micro sites around the internet. We have a complete list at our website, JiggyJaguar.com. Recently, we had Dr. Ted Baer on the program talking advertising with us.
If they said that our media doesn't have any influence, why would somebody buy an ad? Why would somebody buy an ad on your program? Hey, we don't have any impact. There's no reason for you to... So it's a no-brainer.
So check it out right now. We've got everything available at JiggyJaguar.com. Thanks for listening and thanks for supporting Transmedia Worldwide.
What can Plexus do for you? It isn't a secret that being overweight has become a worldwide epidemic. In addition to normal concerns of clothes not fitting, lack of energy, and low self-esteem, being overweight can lead to dramatic increases in diabetes, heart disease, cancer, stroke, arthritis, and depression. Consider the following. 8 out of 10 Americans over the age of 25 are overweight. 174 million Americans are overweight or obese. Then,
worldwide numbers are just crazy. They're expected to double by 2030. 25.8 million children and adults in the United States have diabetes as well. If you're like millions of others, you've probably tried this diet or that pill, but you never got the results you wanted. In fact, the Centers for Disease Control reports that 95% of all diets and weight loss programs fail. Finally, there's an all-natural, healthy solution to help you lose weight. Originally made for diabetics, Plexus Slim is now available. Plexus, PinkDrinkHealth.com. People around the country are experiencing amazing results, and you can too. It's www.PlexusPinkDrinkHealth.com.
How many of you would like to make an extra $21,000 in the next 21 days? Call 678-318-1896 right now for all the details. How many of you would like to receive cash daily to your doorstep? Call 678-318-1896 right now for all the details. What if you had a turnkey system that did all the sorting, sifting, and selling for you? Call 678-318-1896 right now for all the details.
24/7, 365, and available worldwide on the internet. This is the number one talk show online, the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show.
Welcome back to the broadcast, coast to coast, border to border, all over the world wide web, and on 50 plus stations throughout the U.S. and Canada. And KFRK in Denver, Colorado today. We want to thank those guys as well as our good friends over there in Casper, Wyoming at K-Rocks Radio and 24/7 at JiggyJaguar.com on the TuneIn apps and Radio Loyalty. And you can download our podcast if you miss anything at all. You can do that at JiggyJaguar.com. Marius Forte is joining us here in a few moments. He is joining us from Australia, which is fantastic. I'm glad that we were able to make this work today. And the Ukrainian crisis is our topic. Who will stand in the way of Putin if he opts to assimilate the Ukraine? And Marius joins us. Marius, how are you, sir?
I'm doing great. Just a small correction. I'm actually in Austria.
You're in Austria. Okay. Well, right. either way, we made an international call and it worked, so I'm happy. Now, Marius, let's talk about the Ukraine. This is a crazy situation. We've been talking about it all week with everybody, from Malcolm Out Loud to our good, close, personal, longtime friend, Dr. Jack Chiaravelli, who works for Lignet. This is a crazy situation. What is the latest? And kind of give us some updates here, my friend.
Well, you know what? The crux of the matter is really one subject, and that is called credibility. The credibility of the West that is non-existent. We don't have an American leader, and the only way the West could be led is through American leadership. There is no leadership in the West. Germany basically is pacified, and unless Germany would directly be basically attacked, Germany will not act. In France, you have a quasi-socialist communist who is much closer to Putin's ideology, officially not, inofficially absolutely. There is no leadership, so there is no feasible threat. We are sitting and seeing what happened in 1936 all over again. And Putin, no matter if you like him or not, he's a leader. He had this planned. He's executing it. What we see in the Crimea is only the very, very beginning of his plan unrolling. Just like Hitler, after he marched into the Rhineland and was emboldened because nobody did anything. That Second World War could have been avoided. One of the best books you can ever read is Churchill's book, The Gathering Storm, where he talks about exactly that. He was emboldened. The West did nothing. In 1936, France and England had an army that was way superior to that of Germany's. Today, the West, of course, North America has 350 million people, Europe has 450 million, our economies, our armies, besides nuclear, the option, of course, are much, way superior than what Russia has. But we are not acting again, and we are emboldening Putin to do what he's going to do.
Now, we've got Marius Forte with us today, joining us from Austria. Now, I know a lot of you bring up something there that I don't think a lot of people have. In fact, none of our regulars or contributors or anybody has talked about this week. And we've had some people compare Putin to Hitler. I understand the other day that Hillary Clinton compared him to Hitler, and I sort of I don't know. I sort of don't understand when people start comparing all these evil people to Hitler. But you bring up a point there that I have that is actually a valid point. You think just from the way we were talking there, do you think that once he gets the Ukraine, it's going to be like an Adolf Hitler scenario where he just will try to like conquer the world, or you think it's just he just wants to get Russia back together as one nation?
Well, number one, what is happening right now is the very beginning of a larger plan. He didn't just figure that out a couple of months ago. He waited until the Olympics is over. He's taking back the Crimea. They're already starting in the eastern part of the Ukraine. But the West is not acting. We are not doing anything. And unfortunately, like I said, we don't have leadership. So they're going to take the eastern part of Crimea, where they have a strong Russian presence. They're going to take the western Crimea. But what is it to stop of not taking over small countries like Belarus, like the Baltic states? Nobody. Nobody's going to draw that line in the sand because he knows America has no leadership. The only country capable of doing that is America. Imagine this scenario. When this whole thing started, an American leader who would have sent the 6th Fleet into the Black Sea, just sent 40 ships and added a couple of my aircraft carriers. No phone calls, nothing. And suddenly you have the entire 6th Fleet plus a couple of aircraft carriers in the Black Sea, 100 miles offshore. Teddy Roosevelt said, speak softly and carry a big stick. Now a phone call of an American president has a totally different weight. I watch German television, French television here because you get all the stations, the Italian televisions. They are talkers. And Putin knows that. They are talking, they're going to make sanctions. Do you think you can wave a white handkerchief in the face of a gun? Do you think sanctions against tanks, who's going to win? Sanctions or tanks? When Hitler started Second World War, there were exact calculations of how many men, of how many tanks, of what it's going to cost him. He didn't care. And we think that sanctions, that obviously Putin knows that are going to be put in place, are going to hold him off. It's absurd. But these people in Western Europe and America are bureaucrats. They really don't understand Russia, the history of Russia, the history that this country, that these people have suffered, and they've suffered for thousands, and the ability of these people to suffer. So we have not the beginning of an understanding of our enemy, and that's where we're going to fail.
We've got a fantastic guest with us today here on the line. Marius Forte joins us. He was born and raised in Vienna, Austria. He attends. He attended an American school as a young man. He traveled throughout Africa, eventually starting a cement business in Nigeria. After three successful years there, he moved to Saudi Arabia, continued his business ventures in cement and construction. He joins us today here on the line talking about this this incredible situation out there with the Ukraine and Vladimir Putin. The Ukraine situation is a crisis, but Americans are just weary of war and foreign adventures. And even if we did actively engage in another international conflict, what is the likelihood that Obama would pick the right side to go or have an initiative here? Tell me about this. You already said that the leadership is not competent.
Let me give you an example. You come home from your work and you're really tired. I mean, you're really tired.
Yep.
And you go to sleep, and your family's sleeping, right? The last thing you want to do is get out of your bed, and suddenly you realize there are two burglars in your kitchen. And you look down, and you see there aren't. No matter how tired you are, no matter how bad your day was, you have to get up and confront your burglars that have two guns in order to protect your family. That is the situation we face. We don't want war. Nobody in the West wants war. But war can be forced upon you. If you have that burglar who now goes upstairs, you better do something. And that's the situation we are right now. Churchill, again, in The Gathering Storm, a book that is fantastic, it really explains how the Second World War came about, said, after 1936, when Hitler invaded the Rhineland, we could have stopped Hitler. He had no army. He had no army. France and England had a way superior army. There was the biggest peace demonstration after 1936 between Paris and the English Channel, between 1.5 million people. The liberals made a peace demonstration, not against Hitler, no. They demonstrated against Churchill, who was not in power, because he dared to warn the people of what is going to come. We face a similar situation. Nobody wants war, but if Mr. Putin wants war, we will have to have war. We have to defend ourselves, because he will pick up one country after another, and he will not stop, because that is the nature of a bully. So it's not up to us. It's up to him. And we have to react, and we have nobody in the West who is willing to react.
We've got Marius Forte joining us today here on the program. He is absolutely amazing, and we've got him on the line talking about this Ukrainian crisis. There is all sorts of different things going on here. You mentioned that Putin had this set up as to go in after the Olympics. How long do you think he's had this set up? Was this just something he came up with but before the Olympics, or is this a calculated plan?
Well, just look, the foreign minister of Russia lied by saying we don't have Russian troops. We all know, of course, all these troops were brought in without insignia. There's no insignia on their uniforms. So they basically produced uniforms in advance without insignia, pretending that these are whatever they are. And we know how they lied, and we know how Hitler lied. We know how communists lie in general. They had a very lie integrated into the name of their countries, German Democratic Republic. So you cannot listen or believe anything these people say, because he stood there in front of the world press and said, we have nothing to do with this. And we know these are Russian troops. So he prepared it, he prepped it. The Crimea is only the first step. They're already talking about, and they realize they will be emboldened because the West will do absolutely nothing. So if you're a bully and a Putin, you know you're going to go step two and step three. He wants Ukraine back. He said the biggest tragedy was the fall of the Soviet Union. That's what he believes in. He was raised as a communist. He was raised as a murderer, as a KGB agent. He thinks different. He doesn't mind war. He doesn't mind casualties. He thinks in a totally different mindset. And unless we understand how our enemy thinks, we will lose. Show me the leader in the West, and certainly not an American, certainly not Obama, who has a clue of what he's facing. I remember Hillary going to Moscow with that stupid reset button. How much did that do? Nothing. They just thought she's a naive ex-wife of a president.
It is Marius Forte with us today. Marius, do you have another segment in you? Can I put you on
absolutely
hold and be back with you for a few moments?
Because this is truly important what is unfolding in front of our eyes.
Okay, well, we're going to do this. We're going to take a timeout here with Marius, and when we come back, we are going to chat a little bit more about this topic. I know that he is joining us internationally, and this is a fantastic, fantastic topic. We're going to take a timeout. When we come back, we will chat more here on the world-famous Chicky Jaguar Show.
Millie and Cupcake. That's right. Cowcow.com/Millie and Cupcake. Also, check out cafepress.com/Millie and Cupcake, the number one. Also, Millie and Cupcake is available on Amazon. You can purchase the book through our link at JiggyJaguar.com. Millie and Cupcake, available in paperback. Also available for Kindle. It's a story of a girl and her wonderful pet. For many children, the experience of bonding with and loving a first pet is an unforgettable time in their lives. Millie and Cupcake is the charming and educational story of a girl and her companion animal, a different animal than many kids think of when choosing a pet. Check out Millie and Cupcake on Amazon right now. Millie and Cupcake also is available on the web at cowcow.com/Millie and Cupcake. Also cafepress.com/Millie and Cupcake, number one. Tell them you heard about it here on the world famous Chicky Jaguar Show. Let me tell you about search engine optimization that is performance-based. It is SEOgame.com. Visit them online and see the difference. SEOgame puts in over 30 hours of work to start keyword phrase search engine optimization services without a setup fee. Cool? Yeah, it's very cool. If you don't like your results, you can opt out at any time before 30 days without paying a dime. At the end of 30 days, your first payment is due and you get billed monthly thereafter. 5 keyword plans begin at $200 a week. 30 keyword plans begin at $500. If you want your business to grow, you need to get SEO game performance based. SEO. Go to the website right now, SEOgame.com. That's SEOgame.com.
Listeners ask us all the time, how can we support the operation? Head over to our website at www.jiggyjaguar.com. That's right, jiggyjaguar.com. Click on the Amazon banner on our page. It will take you to Amazon. You will still see all the great prices, all the great selection, all the great convenience. But when you shop Amazon, we get a little bit of a credit from Amazon, and it helps us keep the operation going here. Recently, we had best-selling author, National Award winner Dan Perkins on, and he was talking about Amazon.
I listened to your promotion for Amazon.com. You can buy book one and book two, which just came out.
Look at that.
I encourage your listeners to go there and support your operation.
You don't need to buy anything you don't want or need. You just do what you do on Amazon. Buy everything you usually buy there, but do it through our link at jiggyjaguar.com. We get a small percentage, as I mentioned earlier, and it helps really fund our operation. Thanks to our friends at Amazon.com, and thanks for you for supporting us, the great listeners of the world-famous Jiggy Jaguar Radio Broadcast.
Techno-mall.com. Over 2 million homes are burglarized in America each year. Remove your risk of burglary with secure, remote, invisible locks. Without a lock to pick, burglars will struggle to find a way into your home or your business. You can even secure your windows and glass entryways as well. Check out techno-mall.com for more information. Techno-mall.com.
Okay, folks, let's talk about self-development, wealth creation, renewal, and rejuvenation. Are you stuck in a rut? Do you aspire to be something bigger, something better? Well, author Y.E. Shavola has penned two incredible books that will help guide you down a new path, a path that will lead towards self-development, wealth creation, renewal, and rejuvenation. Learn how to make your dreams a reality. You owe it to yourself and your loved ones. Y.E. Shavola's books are available on Amazon right now. How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Self-Development, and How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Wealth Creation. Get them at our website through our Amazon link at jiggyjaguar.com. Find them on Amazon. Check out Y.E. Shavola's incredible books, How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Self-Development, and How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Wealth Creation. Today on Amazon.
24/7, 365, and available worldwide on the internet. This is the number one talk show online, the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show.
Welcome back to the program. Coast to coast, border to border, all over the world wide web, and on 20 AM FM stations across the country and around the world. 24/7 at JiggyJaguar.com on the TuneIn apps and radio loyalty. And our podcast is available over there at JiggyJaguar.com. 2 to 5 Central, 3 to 6 Eastern, and 12 to 3 Pacific. From the KJAG Radio Studios in Hutchinson, Kansas, we are live as live can get. Marius Forte is still with us. And Marius, this is a very, very heavy situation with the Ukraine. What is the worst thing that could happen, and what is the best thing that could happen here, I guess?
Well, let me give you an example. As an Austrian, of course, in history, in June of 1914, the Archduke of Austria was assassinated in Sarajevo. Newspaper articles just prior to that talked about the impossibility of there being a war in the 20th century of Europe. And it was amazing how that one act, the assassination of Archduke Franz Ferdinand of Austria, triggered the First World War, which cost 21 million lives, and the Second World War is really a continuation, a direct continuation of the First World War, the same groups, just with a 20-year peace in between. Something like that is extremely dangerous. And the vacuum that we have in the West makes it even more dangerous. Let me give you an example. When Argentina invaded the Falkland Islands, which I have no strategic importance whatsoever, what did Margaret Thatcher do, a real leader? She sent her navy 8,000 miles down, 8,000 miles, to take those totally unimportant islands back. Why did she do that? She sent a signal to the Russians, because that was in the height of the Cold War. She said, we're willing to defend anything British. Believe me, we're going to defend ourselves. What did Obama do in Syria? He drew imaginary terror lines into some kind of imaginary sand without ever thinking about the consequences that the enemy is listening.
Yep.
That Iran, China, North Korea, and Russia is listening. And they realized, this man is weak. He will never do anything. that embolden exactly what we have today. The consequence of what's happening today in the Ukraine is a direct consequence of the vacuum of a president who used to be a community organizer who never, ever should have been elected American president.
We've got Marius Forte joining us today here on the program, coast to coast and border to border, talking about the Ukraine situation. What do you think is going to happen here the next couple days as we move forward with this?
Well, let me give you an example. Like I said, Hitler calculated exactly what it would cost him the first year, second year of war, the casualties, and he knew that's the price he's going to pay. So if you would have threatened Hitler with certain kind of, you know, sanctions, he would have laughed about it. The same thing right here. This was planned. This is being executed. We're seeing a plan that is unfolding. Now, the West gets together in Paris and talks about sanctions. If you have tanks against sanctions, the tanks are going to win. That's why I say, if you would have done what Teddy Roosevelt suggested many times, which is actually an old African proverb, speak softly and carry a big stick, imagine they would have sent a real leader, just like Thatcher did. She sent her fleet down to the Falkland Islands. Imagine we'd have sent our 6th Fleet into the Black Sea. Whatever the American president would have said from there on, and they have a right to be there, would have had a totally different consequence, and the outcome of what's going to happen now would have been different too. But he knows nobody's willing to do that. Nobody's willing to stop Putin, so it will go forward. He would be a fool not to. He's a bully. He will do that. He will take the Ukraine, and that's just the beginning of what's going to happen. Eventually, we're going to pay a big price. I think this is extremely dangerous. And I think we're seeing the very, very beginning of something that will unfold. We have no leadership in the West.
Now, Marius Forte joins us today here on the program. He joins us talking about the Ukrainian crisis. Who will stand in the way of Putin if he opts to assimilate the Ukraine? And we have learned through the last two segments, Obama's not going to do it. So there's got to be somebody that will that will stand up to this situation. Do you think that this Ukrainian situation and some of these things, obviously, it's something that's going to take. It's not going to take place over a series of years. It'll be something that happens fairly quick. But what happens if this moves and Obama doesn't do anything? Is there going to be anybody else that could step in or step up?
No. The parallels are amazing. And, you know, I don't want to compare Putin with Hitler, but there are parallels. I just read a large article from Karl Schwarzenberg, who used to be the foreign minister of the Czech Republic, and he knows this situation. He knows these countries through his family history extremely well. And he did compare it to 1936-38. When Hitler picked off Austria, and nobody did anything. In Vienna, we have a place called the Mexico Place. And the reason why it's called the Mexico Place is because Mexico was the only country that put in a formal protest when Hitler annexed Austria. Then he said, you know what, my next country, I have to defend the Sudeten. These people were called the Sudetendeutsche, and the Germans that live in Sudetenland in the Czech Republic. Then he took Czechoslovakia. And then he moved on to Poland. And then finally, England and France declared war on Germany, but the strange thing was, there was no war. After Hitler took Poland in 6 weeks, there was no war all the way until next April because people were tired of war. They declared war, but they didn't really mean it. And with every day, Hitler got emboldened and got stronger and stronger. We have going to have a very similar situation here. We have a bully who will not stop. It is like a cancer. Cancers don't stop themselves. They don't spread in your body until Thursday, 8:15, and then they say, we have enough. They want the whole thing. Bullies want the whole thing. The only thing that can stop a bully is somebody who really means what he says, like Thatcher. We don't have a Thatcher. We don't have a Reagan. We don't have a Bush. We have a community organizer in the White House as a leader. We're in really bad shape. Let me just give you some statistics. America's gross national product is $16.7 trillion. Europe's gross national product is $15.8 trillion. Russia's is $2.6. There is no comparison. We have 800 million people in the West, just in Europe and North America. Russia has 180 million. We have an army, besides the nuclear option, that is way, way superior to that of Russia. Yet that small country with a third-rate army of today is going to push us around, just like Hitler pushed around France and England with a much smaller, because he was a leader and he knew where he's going. And we had at that time Chamberlain in office in England, who had many meetings, and was fooled by Hitler, and nobody was standing up to the bully. So that's why Karl Schwarzenberg said there are absolute comparables to what happened then and what's happening now.
We've got Marius Forte with us today here on the program. And Marius, as we go, how can people connect with you online if they want to get more information?
Well, we launched a book. It is called The Answer, Proof of God in Heaven. It is available on Amazon. We have a website. It is called theanswer-book.com, theanswer-book.com. Through my travels, I realized the question about faith, even if you're an agnostic, an atheist, if you're Muslim, a Jew, a Christian, the question is always the same because we do go through the same gates of life. The answers are very different. And the book that we wrote really proves the existence of God via science. The book is not about religion, even though I'm a religious Catholic. But the book truly proves the existence of God in an amazing, simplistic way. It's got 21 chapters. Those are the chapters that I was always confronted, no matter where I was, like I said, in Africa, in Saudi Arabia, in the Middle East. People have the same questions. And I believe our book truly answers the questions about where we come from, where we're going to, why we're going at all, why is God the way he is? Is there good and evil? How can a good God permit evil? And how can we prove the existence of God?
Well, Marius, I appreciate you joining us today, and fantastic interview as always, and we'll talk to you soon.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.
Appreciate it. Friends, please take a moment to make a difference. They need our help. www.pathelpingpeoplefoundationinc.com. That's PATHELPING peoplefoundationinc.com. They have to raise some money to continue their services and help to provide to those in need. $10. It may not seem like much to change someone's life today. It may not change the world, but it will help make a difference to change someone's world. Please make a pledge, friends, to help support this organization, as we so often do for other organizations, and please help. And please, friends, pass the word on to your Facebook, Twitter, Glide, YouTube, WhatsApp, Pinterest friends as well, in support of this organization. Thank you, and may God bless. That's www.pathelpingpeoplefoundationinc.com.
Attention, everyone. Is your computer getting slow? Are errors popping up all over the screen? You need QuickSpeed PC. Get your free scan today at quickspeedpc.com and speed your computer up like new. That's quickspeedpc.com for your free scan today. Go to quickspeedpc.com today. quickspeedpc.com.
The response has been overwhelming, and we thank you guys for shopping the Amazon link at JiggyJaguar.com. Check it out today at JiggyJaguar.com. Recently, we spoke to another guest on our radio program, and he had this to say about Amazon.
I know you guys work with Amazon a lot.
Yes.
It's the number one mouthwash on Amazon.
We're not asking you to buy anything you don't want or need. You know you're going to do your shopping at Amazon. You might as well help out the broadcast at the same time. To help out our operation, check out JiggyJaguar.com. That's JiggyJaguar.com, and thanks for supporting the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show.
Somewhere over the rainbow lies a pot of gold that's sure to make your next fundraising event a huge success. Rainbow Dust, the innovative and exciting project that is a must-have for any fundraiser, is the hottest interactive candy product on the market today. Visit www.myrainbowdust.com to see how Rainbow Dust can add magic to your next function. Find out why kids will be standing in line for their turn at making their own delicious Rainbow Dust candy creation. Use the promo code RADIO2 to receive free ground shipping. MyRainbowDust.com. Let the magic begin.
Welcome back to the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show, coast to coast, border to border, all over the world wide web.
24/7, 365, and available worldwide on the internet. This is the number one talk show online, the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show.
You gotta love the quintessential player. Oh, it's a Thursday, which means that the equipment's not working. And we've got Shannon Rose from the Hollywood Rose Report going to be joining us here in a few moments. The letter I, the letter M, ShannonRose.com. And if you want to follow him on Twitter, you can do so, Shannon K. Rose. Or find him on Facebook, Shannon Rose Hollywood. And before we do that, this segment of the big broadcast is brought to you by our good friends over there at Stitcher.com. Check out Stitcher.com/JiggyJaguar for more information. And when you download Stitcher, be sure to put in that promo code box. Put in J-I-G-G-Y, J-A-G-G-U-A-R, and you can get registered to win $100 from Stitcher. And Shannon Rose with us today. Shannon, there is a lot of different things going on in Hollywood. Michael Jackson apparently has a 31-year-old son. What?
Before we get started, Jiggy,
yeah.
We have 13,000 followers on Twitter now. Thank you for plugging it. I'm sure with your help that got us to 13,000 people on Twitter. 13,000? Yeah, when we talked last week, I was trying to get 100 at one point. Now we've grown and grown and grown.
Well, that is fantastic, my friend. It is Shannon Rose with us today, and this Michael Jackson thing. How did he get a 31-year-old son, man?
there's a singer that is the mom of this alleged Michael Jackson kid. He's 31 years old. You would think he would come out earlier, but he's coming out now, and he's claiming that he is Michael Jackson's kid, and he says the DNA proves it. And they'll have to actually do a DNA. They're talking about doing a DNA in court coming up and seeing, and at that point, I'm sure they're going to go up to the estate.
Oh, that's why this. Okay. I see why things have happened the way that they have. Okay. Shannon Rose with us today, the Hollywood Rose Report. You can get more information at the letter I, the letter M, ShannonRose.com. And Toronto Mayor Rob Ford says he's done partying. He has an election to win. Really? He's done partying?
Well, you know, he came out and said he did crack, and you see him, he looks like Chris Farley, the late Chris Farley, the way he acts, and he was on Jimmy Kimmel sweating. Like a stuck pig, and he was, going off and saying that him partying is going to be stopping because he wants to win the election. He said he saved the Toronto area millions of dollars as mayor. But we'll have to see if they actually like all the exploitation of what he's been doing and see if he's going to be retaining the title of mayor.
It's Shannon Rose with us today, the letter I, the letter M, ShannonRose.com. Find him on Twitter at Shannon K. Rose. Bill Cosby's returning to network TV with a family comedy show. Why?
Well, we miss the Huxtables, and it's going to be very much like the Huxtable Cosby show back
yep.
in the day. He tried to come back on TV. But I think, NBC is trying to, I think it's NBC is going to appear on, but they're trying to reclaim the old, of the nostalgia of shows. That, Big Bang Theory always gives me, an idea of the show that used to be back in the day of, where you had the canned laughter, and it's a very funny show. And
yep.
Well, they're trying to bring back that formula.
It's Shannon Rose with us today. TLC has ordered 12 half-hour episodes of a reality series. Following Leah Remini around, she, of course, was on CBS long-running Comedy King of Queens. She also was on a syndicated show, The Talk, and she's been in a bunch of different movies and some short-lived television pilots. Why are they following her around?
Well, they're following around. In the reality shows, they don't just put something on the air. They test it out. It gets marketed in front of crowds, and I think it's going to do okay. But I'm not really interested in Leah Remini. She doesn't. Here's a little backstory though. I did a movie. I appeared in a movie From Earth to the Moon with Tom Hanks, and I was a featured extra where I actually had a talking line. And we were there from something like 4 a.m. to 4 a.m. So there was a lot of time to kill. And in the middle of the night, nothing was going on. They would reshoot a scene literally 50 times, different different sides of the scene, and then they would edit it all together. Well, there was a piano there, and Leah Remini was in one of the episodes. So was the dad in Wonder Years, Dan Loria. So was the guy on Kids in the Hall. He was actually
yep. there,
too. But Leah Remini was there, and she just started to get on the piano and with all the extras around and started singing. And she was all A-list actor, and usually they have their own trailer, and, you know, they have what they're called, craft services, and they do
yep.
their own thing.
Yep.
But here... She decided to spend time with the extras. But I don't know if it's going to be of interest to me to watch what she does, other than maybe her dates or, you know, find out why she's no longer in the talk.
It is. Shannon Rose with us today. The fantastic Shannon Rose is available at the letter I, the letter M, ShannonRose.com. And Pee-wee Herman has this bicycle, and he's selling it? Is that what's going on, or...?
Yeah, you can go on eBay now and buy part of Pee-wee's Playhouse or Pee-wee's movie. I think it was from The Big Adventure, you know, that famous bike. But it really, are you going to want to buy a piece, like a seat or a wheel or, you know, for $8,000? But they're selling each item for $8,000.
I don't understand why anybody would want to buy a piece of the bike, but... I don't know.
Well, I tell you what, you know, it's one of those things where, you know, why can't you just sell the whole bike right now?
Exactly. Why can't we just buy the damn thing? And there would be people that would buy that damn thing. In fact, Kenny Zombie Jones would buy that bike immediately. I know he would. But yeah. Why can't we just buy the whole damn thing?
Well, you know, it's one of those. Somebody tried to sell their kidney on eBay. And they also, just recently, I don't know if you saw the story, they tried to sell a finger on eBay.
Okay. I guess. I guess you can buy anything on eBay. We've got Shannon Rose with us today, the letter I, the letter M, ShannonRose.com. Before we let Shannon go, we always have to talk one wrestling story. I watched Monday Night Raw from Chicago, and there was all this crap on social media about, oh, they were going to hijack Raw and all these things. How do you think that turned out?
Well, I tell you what, I think that it ended up... you know, I think they teased. I thought they were actually going to bring Wade Barrett out and try to, you know, play CM Punk's music. But I think Paul Heyman was awesome. I think that he is intelligent, smart, and I think that everything went well with that. But, you know, I think CM Punk's done. If he didn't show up in Chicago, he's done. And I think, you know, it's swan song. I think it's over. But, you know, they did what they had to do, and I think they pacified the crowd, and then they moved on, which was a smart way to do it.
Yeah. Well, it's Shannon Rose with us today, and you can get more information on the letter I, the letter M, ShannonRose.com. Follow him on Twitter at Shannon K. Rose. And Shannon, thanks for being with us today, and looking forward to talking to you next week, sir.
Thank you, man.
Appreciate it, man. Later. It's Shannon Rose. When we come back, we've got more here on the big broadcast. Hour number 3 coming up. Famous Jiggy Jake Wire Show, coast to coast, border to border, all over the World Wide Web. We've got a fantastic, fantastic marketing partner I want to tell you about right now. It is the website cool-post.com.
Lite.com/LITE. You need to go there right now. Check these guys out. They are simply, simply amazing. Cool. Dashpost.com/LITE. These guys have been in the business for a heck of a long time. They know what they're talking about. And multi-mail channels, they've got that. Box Trapper. You need to check out Box Trapper. I cannot say anything more. Box Trapper is absolutely amazing. It also allows the user to decide what spam/junk and allow full access to their incoming mail queue and their own whitelist, ignore list, blacklist. By the way, absolutely, absolutely amazing stuff. The multi-channels on this, just amazing stuff. Mail channels, these guys have got it all. You need to go over and check out cool-post.com/LITE. And I want to give you a little bit more information on what these guys are doing. They've got email service, your own host, your own choice of domain. It's absolutely amazing. Also secure, private, and confidential. The data is not shared. Spam Assassin. It is enabled. Multi-channels, mail channels, amazing stuff. Mail channels are protected. Also includes squirrel mail, webmail access, horde webmail access. That is important. And you know, if you're an email person, you know that horde webmail access is absolutely, absolutely incredible. Round cube webmail access. That's right. Also pop. SMTP, IMAP, and SSL access. Unlimited storage, email trace tool as well. User managed, you can do filters, forwards, autoresponders, auto inbox cleaning, and vacation toggle. Plus Box Trapper config. What this means is your settings, your messages, your whitelist, your ignore list, your blacklists, your forward list, and your log and your queue all at your disposal. The social networks are involved also. Unlimited free auctions. Think about that. That's fantastic. Also, unlimited free bidding. Free recruiter services along with free freelancer services. And there's not a lot of places that do that. So that is absolutely incredible. Free classifieds as well. Full feature blogging. Groups. Brainstorming. Map sharing. Map of members worldwide. Event management and video and photo sharing as well. Also, a lot of other things that I don't want to talk about here on the radio. I don't want to give it away. Go check it out over there at cool-post.com/LITE. Smartphone community as well. Extended access, blogs, groups, profiles, microblogging as well. File sharing and page publishing. Bookmark sharing as well. You can join up at cool-post.com/LITE. No parent company ads, no enforced format passwords, no forced password resets, no enforced logins, and no lockouts without a dialogue. You can check it out today at cool-post.com/LITE. Affiliate opportunities as well. Every user is included on this one. They're not going to just let certain users in there. Everybody is included. Multi-level payouts, level on each of 50 levels, random setups as well, bonus resources, and optional white labeling. And that is big, as everybody knows, in the profit share world. Optional white labeling, absolutely, absolutely amazing. Daily withdrawals to a PayPal and daily withdrawals to Pay2. And, of course, we all know about Pay2. Pay2 is P-A-Y-T-O-O. Check that out when you get a chance. They do that over there at cool-post.com/LITE. Reliable mail service. Safe and social networking as well. Amazing profit shares. These guys are they're one of our big marketing partners, and this is one of the reasons why, is because they always help people out. They do payments by PayPal, MasterCard, Visa, Maestro, American Express. They have it all over there at cool-post.com/LITE. That's the website. You want to check it out today. It's cool-post.com/LITE. And we're back with more here on the program in just a few moments. Millie and Cupcake. That's right. Cowcow.com/Millie and Cupcake. Also, check out cafepress.com/Millie and Cupcake, the number one. Also, Millie and Cupcake is available on Amazon. You can purchase the book through our link at JiggyJaguar.com. Millie and Cupcake, available in paperback. Also available for Kindle. It's a story of a girl and her wonderful pet. For many children, the experience of bonding with and loving a first pet is an unforgettable time in their lives. Millie and Cupcake is the charming and educational story of a girl and her companion animal, a different animal than many kids think of when choosing a pet. Check out Millie and Cupcake on Amazon right now. Millie and Cupcake also is available on the web at cowcow.com/Millie and Cupcake. Also cafepress.com/Millie and Cupcake, number one. Tell them you heard about it here on the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show. Let me tell you about search engine optimization that is performance-based. It is SEOgame.com. Visit them online and see the difference. SEOgame puts in over 30 hours of work to start keyword phrase search engine optimization services without a setup fee. Cool? Yeah, it's very cool. If you don't like your results, you can opt out at any time before 30 days without paying a dime. At the end of 30 days, your first payment is due and you get billed monthly thereafter. 5 keyword plans begin at $200 a week. 30 keyword plans begin at $500. If you want your business to grow, you need to get SEO game performance based. SEO. Go to the website right now, SEOgame.com. That's SEOgame.com. Techno-Mall.com. Over 2 million homes are burglarized in America each year. Remove your risk of burglary with secure, remote, invisible locks. Without a lock to pick, burglars will struggle to find a way into your home or your business. You can even secure your windows and glass entryways as well. Check out Techno-Mall.com for more information. Techno-Mall.com.
Okay, folks, let's talk about self-development, wealth creation, renewal, and rejuvenation. Are you stuck in a rut? Do you aspire to be something bigger, something better? Well, author Y.E. Shavola has penned two incredible books that will help guide you down a new path, a path that will lead towards self-development, wealth creation, renewal, and rejuvenation. Learn how to make your dreams a reality. You owe it to yourself and your loved ones. Y.E. Shavola's books are available on Amazon right now. How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Self-Development, and How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Wealth Creation. Get them at our website through our Amazon link at JiggyJaguar.com. Find them on Amazon. Check out Y.E. Shavola's incredible books, How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Self-Development, and How to Occupy Till Jesus Comes, Wealth Creation. Today on Amazon.
Now, the Jiggy Jaguar Show on JiggyJaguar.com.
Welcome back to hour number three of the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show. You can get a hold of us at JiggyJaguar.com on the TuneIn apps and Radio Loyalty and listen to us each and every day on 50-plus AM FM stations across the country. Victor Davis Hanson joins us today here on the program. We are going to talk about the Ukraine, but we also want to talk about how hard will it be on a post-President Obama presidency. And Victor Davis is with us today, Victor Davis Hanson. Victor, welcome to the program. How are you, sir?
Very good. Thank you for having me.
Now, let's talk a little bit about this. How hard will it be on the post-President Obama president? This is a fantastic, fantastic article that is available at PJ Media. Tell us about this, and then let's chat about it here.
Well, Obama is exercising certain options as president that he would object, and he did object, when he perceived anybody else would do the same. So when he's out of office, what is the left or the media going to do if the next president decides that the Endangered Species Act is unconstitutional? And he decides that on his own, so he just decides by an executive order he's not going to uphold it or what happens if they do pass comprehensive immigration reform, the next president, as Obama did with his own health care plan, decides that he thinks it's unconstitutional, so he's just going to start deporting people. Or what happens if the next president gives deadlines and deadlines and deadlines and red lines and red lines and red lines and step over lines and step over lines from Syria to Ukraine? Is the left going to go back on the attack as they did during Iraq and Afghanistan? And what if the next president comes in and says, you know, the deficits are so high, I'm going to half them. I'm going to make sure they're in half by the end of my first term. And then he has $5 trillion deficits, $5 trillion deficits in a row. So whether we like it or not, we're doing certain things in this administration that liberal-thinking people would not want to see repeated by any other president.
It is Victor Davis Hanson with us today here on the program. There's a we had earlier today, we had Marius Forte on talking about this Ukrainian situation, and he mentioned that President Obama just he's not the guy that can stand up to Vladimir Putin. Do you think that there will be someone post presidency? Will we get someone that is a big talker and someone who can make some stuff happen?
I don't know, but I know that it's not wise to talk loudly and then to be weak, or not. It's not wise to talk loudly and even be strong. It's much better to talk softly and to carry a big stick. So Putin doesn't believe that Obama is going to do things that he says he's going to do, and he does think. That the things he promises to do are not going to be serious. So we keep thinking he's rational, he's logical. He's not acting in his own interest as we see his own interest. He seems to think that what he's doing makes sense if you were Vladimir Putin and you were Russia. And you either have to say, you know what, he's a thug and he's going to take as much of the old Soviet Union as he can. There's nothing we're going to stop it, so just keep quiet, or lecture him, remonstrate with him, warn him, threaten him, but then be prepared for him to call your bluff. And unfortunately, we're lecturing him and calling him names and doing all this, but we're not willing to enforce what we say, just like in Syria or Iran or in Libya or you name it. So the world is watching, and they're trying to think, what does the United States do when it's confronted with a Syria or Iran, or it gets out of Iraq, or it bombs and leaves from behind in Libya, or it flips in Egypt. And the people who are thinking this are in China, they're in North Korea, they're in Iran, and they're watching Putin very carefully because they think, well, if he can slice off the Crimea, or maybe he can go to the Baltic states next, and maybe he can take some more of Georgia, maybe he can even go back and take all of Ukraine. If he can do that, then surely we can do something with Taiwan or Japanese islands or the DMZ, or we can get a bomb in Iran. And that's the danger as I see it.
We've got Victor Davis Hanson joining us today here on from PJMedia.com. He's got a great article up there on PJMedia.com. And the appointments is a section that you have in here. Of the article, I know that there was recently Obama, some of the appointees that he has have been struck down. What do you see coming with a post-Obama presidency?
Let's just decide that some right-wing guy is elected, a Republican is. Let's say he's from Utah or Montana, and let's say that
he wants
to appoint right-wing people. So instead of Obama tried to appoint somebody's civil rights attorney who defended a cop killer, let's say that we got an attorney general who defended somebody who blew up an abortion clinic. What's the left going to say? You wouldn't dare appoint somebody to the attorney general staff who actually defended an abortion bomber, would you? And they're going to say, well, you appointed somebody that defended a cop killer and even raised money for him. Or what if we had somebody who said, I'm going to be the new president's communications director. My hero was Mussolini. And they
wow.
got angry, and they said, how can you dare do that? And they said, well, Obama appointed Anita Dunn. She said her hero was Mao Zedong, and he killed 60 million people, more than Mussolini ever dreamed of. So whether it's Van Jones or whether it's these ambassadors or putting Carolyn Kennedy as ambassador to Japan or whatever he's doing, it's putting the media and the liberal establishment in a very difficult position, because it means that it's okay for an executive order right now. It's okay to ignore settled law right now. It's okay to make these appointments right now. If you have Eric Holder, and he's the Attorney General of the United States, and he says, refers to African Americans as my people, and he calls the country cowardly on race matters, what if you bring in, I don't know, John Ashcroft again? And John Ashcroft says, you know what, there's a white person. He said, that's my people. Or he said, you know what, I'm going to end affirmative action, and this country's too cowardly to deal with it. That would be an outrage. Or if you have a new FCC commissioner, and she's the daughter of John Ashcroft, and she says, you know, I think we need to monitor local radio stations such as your own and see if they're really dealing with issues like patriotism, traditional marriage, family values. We want the FCC to monitor what they're broadcasting and see if it collates and reflects what our views of America are. You can imagine what the New York Times or PBS or NPR would say.
Oh, they would go out of their minds.
They would, and we're seeing that every single day. And the problem with all that is that he's destroyed all of the normal accepted protocols, whether it's a filibuster in the Senate or whether it's controversial appointments. Or what if the next president said, you know, I like Boeing so much, I just hope that they locate their next aircraft plant in Mississippi or Alabama where there's no unions. People would be outraged at that. Or if we were bailing out GM, they went in and said, you know what, let's make sure that those union pensioners don't get any money, and even though they're ahead of the creditors, we'll put them behind the creditors because we just don't think that they have a right to get money that's been lost. He did that with the creditors at GM. We could do this all day long. That's what I'm trying to get at.
Yeah.
This is an insidious abuse of presidential power, and he can get away with it because he assumes that, A, the media is not going to say anything, and B, his exalted aims justify any means necessary to achieve them. But he's not always going to be president. And so what he's basically doing is giving a blank check for anybody of the opposite party to do exactly what he did. And when the left starts to complain, they'll have no credibility whatsoever.
Victor Davis Hanson joins us today here on the program, Coast to Coast and Border to Border. And you can get more information on this article at pjmedia.com. Check it out today. How hard will it be on the post-Obama president? And Victor, thanks for being with us. And I appreciate your candor and your information. And we'll talk soon, my friend. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Definitely. Have yourself a wonderful day. Victor Davis Hanson with us today here on the program. And we are going to take a smidgen of a timeout. When we come back, we've got more.
Dear friends, please take a moment to make a difference. They need our help. www.pathelpingpeoplefoundationinc.com. That's PATHELPING, peoplefoundationinc.com. They have to raise some money to continue their services and help to provide to those in need. $10. It may not seem like much to change someone's life today. It may not change the world, but it will help make a difference to change someone's world. Please make a pledge, friends, to help support this organization, as we so often do for other organizations, and please help. And please, friends, pass the word on to your Facebook, Twitter, Glide, YouTube, WhatsApp, Pinterest friends as well, in support of this organization. Thank you, and may God bless. That's www.pathelpingpeoplefoundationinc.com.
Attention, everyone. Is your computer getting slow? Are errors popping up all over the screen? You need QuickSpeed PC. Get your free scan today at quickspeedpc.com and speed your computer up like new. That's quickspeedpc.com for your free scan today. Go to quickspeedpc.com today.
quickspeedpc.com.
It's a new year here at the world-famous Jiggy Jaguar Show, and we are ramping up for a tremendous, tremendous 2014. We have a lot of things coming up this year. We're doing a lot of television projects, going to be doing a lot of radio as well, and we need your help. Shop our Amazon.com links. You can do all of your shopping through our website at JiggyJaguar.com. That's JiggyJaguar.com. It's as simple as clicking on our Amazon link. That will take you to Amazon. Amazon will still look the same. It'll still feel the same. You'll still get the same deals. We just get a little bit of help off a commission from Amazon if you do shopping through our link. Also, we have our advertising available on Fiverr.com, as well as many of these other micro sites around the internet. We have a complete list at our website, JiggyJaguar.com. Recently, we had Dr. Ted Baer on the program talking advertising with us.
If they said that our media doesn't have any influence, why would somebody buy an ad? Why would somebody buy an ad on your program? Hey, we don't have any impact. There's no reason for you to... So it's a no-brainer.
So check it out right now. We've got everything available at JiggyJaguar.com. Thanks for listening and thanks for supporting Transmedia Worldwide.
Somewhere over the rainbow lies a pot of gold that's sure to make your next fundraising event a huge success. Rainbow Dust, the innovative and exciting project that is a must-have for any fundraiser, is the hottest interactive candy product on the market today. Visit www.myrainbowdust.com to see how Rainbow Dust can add magic to your next function. Find out why kids will be standing in line for their turn at making their own delicious Rainbow Dust candy creation. Use the promo code RADIO2 to receive free grand shipping. MyRainbowDust.com. Let the magic begin.
Back to the Jiggy Jaguar Show on the network.
Welcome back to the broadcast, coast to coast, border to border, all over the world wide web, and on 50 plus stations throughout the U.S. and Canada. Thanks for tuning in to the big broadcast from the Kate Jag Radio Studios in Hutchinson, Kansas. We are live 2 to 5 Central, 3 to 6 Eastern, and 12 to 3 Pacific. We're 24-7 at JiggyJaguar.com on the TuneIn apps and Radio Loyalty. And our podcast is available over there at JiggyJaguar.com. Mark Davis joins us. He is a fantastic, fantastic guy. We wanted to get him on today to chat about a myriad of topics. Mark, how are you, sir?
I'm very well, thank you. I really appreciate you having me on today.
Now, Mark, I'm going to let you take this first segment, kind of lead us in a direction here, and I'll catch up, my friend. What do you want to speak about? What is the most important thing we need to speak about in this first segment?
For the first segment, I believe Obamacare is disintegrating, and we're watching it as of today and yesterday. Many changes are coming forward, and it's a milestone in how decrement the Obamacare legislation is. It was announced today that traditional insurances, by and large, will be allowed to stay in effect until 2017, well past the presidential election of 2016. Why? Because it's disintegrating. They cannot implement all the tenets of Obamacare at this time, and they can't control, as they thought they could, the traditional insurance route that people usually take. Also was announced today that the codes that doctors and hospitals use to bill or to schedule patients, there are 17,000 of these. They're called, it's an international classification of diseases, ICD codes. There are 17,000. Now there'll be 155,000 as of October 2014. What that does basically is cause confusion in the entire system. Doctors will not know how to bill, when to bill, where to bill. This is something that's a detriment to the entire system, and many doctors will probably just leave their practices. If not, they'll curtail or close their practices to new patients. This is a horror story in development right now in terms of Obamacare, and we need all to be aware of what's going on. We had the president lie to us recently, very, very recently, claiming there were 4 million people on the exchanges. What the president didn't tell us was, are these people that are being subsidized? In other words, are they being taken off of medical assistance, which is a subsidizing program, and put on the exchanges, which is another subsidized program? We need, in order to make Obamacare work, they need to subsidize the program with young people. Young people need to buy into the system. If they don't, then the system doesn't work. The algorithm, the formula fails. So there's a lot of things going on. I think we should direct our attention in this segment to Obamacare.
Well, with Obamacare, there's a lot of people that they're not really talking about this because there's a lot of different things going on in the Ukraine and other places. What is some of the biggest? I guess you mentioned young people. I guess is that the biggest situation with Obamacare?
No. People are being forced off their insurances because companies are either downsizing, they can't afford to give their employees a health insurance. So if they go from a 40-hour work week to a 29-hour work week, they don't have to give the insurance. But even that has been delayed by Obama. Obama has gone in and changed the legislation a minimum of 29 times now through executive edict, order, and the Health and Human Services is also withholding mandatory regulatory structure that's required of the legislation past 2014 election. So this is all political. It's being bounced around, and I see it as an endpoint that this system will implode in the next year or two. I don't think it's going to survive that long even at this rate, because Obama has too big of an ego to admit that it's a failure. So he's going to let it keep going on and on and on and on, and that's exactly what's happening right now. Now, the 2014 election, this is the time to help change Obamacare, and what you do is you go there and vote the right way and get those dead fossils, whether they're left or right, out of the system and put new fresh blood in there. At the minimum, Obamacare needs to be modulated. At the maximum, as I feel, it should be revoked, buried, and sent overseas somewhere. Maybe it could work better there. It will not work in our democracy. And as much as Obama wants to do, this is a democracy still, but he's trying to change it, as you know. As for the Ukraine, we should stay out of there. None of our business. Let Putin do what he does.
Okay, there's a lot of people that we've been talking about this week that have been talking about how we need to get in there, we need to do this, we need to do that.
I speak some Russian and I speak multiple other languages, and I'll tell you something: the Russians watch over Russians, and Putin goes, he doesn't ask Obama, a weak president, he does what he wants to do, and he's going to do what he wants to do. And John Kerry, even the $1 billion that he's presenting to the Ukrainians, is not going to be enough to overcome what Putin wants to do. And then that's basically it. We should stay out of there. We've been in too many wars. We're too spread out. I don't think Putin wants to start a war over there anyway, from the information I've gotten on this side. And we have more internal things to worry about, like Obamacare, destroying jobs, businesses, hospitals. Many hospitals are closing now, as an example, from Obamacare, directly because of Obamacare. So what are we doing over there running around the world telling other people what to do? And if you remember, just a short time ago, Putin blocked us from blowing up Syria. And so Putin was the peacemaker at that time. How do you explain that?
That's the thing. How do you explain that?
Well, because he doesn't want war. He's not interested in war. He's interested in control. That's a lot different than being war. Russia's had a horrible history of wars, going back to World War I, World War II. And if it wasn't for Russians, we would have never won World War II in Europe. Why? Because they came in from the west, we came in from the other side, and that's basically it. Eastern Europe was conquered. By and large, we got rid of the Germans because of the Russians coming in there. We didn't have enough manpower to do it ourselves. And the history speaks for itself, and now history repeats itself. Ukrainians, there are a lot of Russians in Ukraine, and then Putin wants to protect them. That's how I view it. What are we doing there? What are we protecting? Who are we protecting? Why are we sending our aircraft carriers over there? Are we planning to start the war? It doesn't make any sense from the standpoint that I see. And we have such a weak president who has no backbone at all. And if he had backbone, he'd say, look, if you really want to do something, we'll decimate you financially. But he's not doing any of that. It's just a bunch of weak sanctions, again, as he always does.
We've got Mark Davis with us today, 26 minutes after the hour. And, Mark, we're going to take a quick timeout here. When we come back, we're going to chat a little bit more with you about some of the other topics of the day. Mark Davis joins us here on the big broadcast.
Are you out of work? Are you looking to make a lot of money on the internet from the comfort of your home? I have consistently made over $30,000 every month for the past 8 years. I have received daily $900 payments, $1,800 payments, $3,000 payments, and even $10,000 payments. It's fun, it's easy, and beginners are desperately needed right now. Sign up today at www.pcmteambuilder.com/CouponJoe and make potentially $30,000 a month just like I did. Again, the website address is www.pcmteambuilder.com/CouponJoe.
What can Plexus do for you? It isn't a secret that being overweight has become a worldwide epidemic. In addition to normal concerns of clothes not fitting, lack of energy, and low self-esteem, being overweight can lead to dramatic increases in diabetes, heart disease, cancer, stroke, arthritis, and depression. Consider the following. 8 out of 10 Americans over the age of 25 are overweight. 174 million Americans are overweight or obese. Then worldwide numbers are just crazy. They're expected to double by 2030. 25.8 million children and adults in the United States have diabetes as well. If you're like millions of others, you've probably tried this diet or that pill, but you never got the results you wanted. In fact, the Centers for Disease Control reports that 95% of all diets and weight loss programs fail. Finally, there's an all-natural, healthy solution to help you lose weight, originally made for diabetics. Plexus Slim is now available. PlexusPinkDrinkHealth.com. People around the country are experiencing amazing results, and you can too. It's www.PlexusPinkDrinkHealth.com.
It's a new year here at the world-famous Jiggy Jaguar Show, and we are ramping up for a tremendous, tremendous 2014. We have a lot of things coming up this year. We're doing a lot of television projects, going to be doing a lot of radio as well. And we need your help. Shop our Amazon.com links. You can do all of your shopping through our website at JiggyJaguar.com. That's JiggyJaguar.com. It's as simple as clicking on our Amazon link. That will take you to Amazon. Amazon will still look the same. It'll still feel the same. You'll still get the same deals. We just get a little bit of help off a commission from Amazon if you do shopping through our link. Also, we have our advertising available on Fiverr.com, as well as many of these other micro sites around the internet. We have a complete list at our website, JiggyJaguar.com. Recently, we had Dr. Ted Baer on the program talking advertising with us.
If they said that our media doesn't have any influence, why would somebody buy an ad? Why would somebody buy an ad on your program? Hey, we don't have any impact. There's no reason for you to... So it's a no-brainer.
So check it out right now. We've got everything available at JiggyJaguar.com. Thanks for listening and thanks for supporting Transmedia Worldwide.
Dear friends, please take a moment to make a difference. They need our help. www.pathelpingpeoplefoundationinc.com. That's PathelpingPeopleFoundationInc, PeopleFoundationInc.com. They have to raise some money to continue their services and help to provide to those in need. $10. It may not seem like much to change someone's life today. It may not change the world, but it will help make a difference to change someone's world. Please make a pledge, friends, to help support this organization, as we so often do for other organizations. And please help. And please, friends, pass the word on to your Facebook, Twitter, Glide, YouTube, WhatsApp, Pinterest friends as well, in support of this organization. Thank you, and may God bless. That's www.PathelpingPeopleFoundationInc.com.
How many of you would like to make an extra $21,000 in the next 21 days? Call 678-318-1896 right now for all the details. How many of you would like to receive cash daily to your doorstep? Call 678-318-1896 right now for all the details. What if you had a turnkey system that did all the sorting, sifting, and selling for you? Call 678-318-1896 right now for all the details.
Now,
the Jiggy Jaguar Show on JiggyJaguar.com.
Welcome back to the program, Coast to Coast, Border to Border. We have Mark Davis joining us. He is just a fantastic, fantastic guy. We wanted to get him on to chat today with us. And we were talking about Obamacare in the last segment. I do want to chat with him about the situation regarding President Obama and Obamacare. I know, we talked about the last segment. Kind of pick it up where we left off and bring us up to speed on what we were talking about here, my friend.
Obamacare is a legislative nightmare. Revealed in 2010, March 23rd, when it was signed into law, it has a super number of tenants that require doctors, hospitals, and people who come into the system to play or act in a certain way in the healthcare system. Basically, it tries to control every aspect of the healthcare system. It does this by a series of sanctions, penalties, taxes, and not liens yet. They haven't come into liens yet. And early on, prior to its passage, they were even talking about jailing doctors who don't follow Obamacare, as was noted by some of the legislators. So that would be an extreme example of what could happen down the road, but cannot happen right now. We need millions of people to pay into the system to make the system work, because the algorithm, the amount of money that needs to come in, is so great, it cannot provide what it's advertising. Free health care to those that need subsidies, people that need advanced surgeries and things like that are very expensive, and we're not going to get this from Obamacare. There's just too much information in Obamacare to apply to 317 million people. So at the end of the day, what you get is less and less and less, but you pay more and more and more. So Obamacare will fail in the next year or two. I don't think we need to do much to it. It's just going to implode on its own.
Well, Mark, a lot of people are asking when this does fail, and a lot of people have said, you know, if they were going to repeal it or get rid of it, what would you do to replace it with? What's the system there?
I would go back to the system that we had, and I would concentrate definitely on the people who need the help, the 15%, so-called 15% that the government says out there that are not having health care, which is not really factual. But anyway, that's where we should concentrate our resources. We are not doing that. We need a tune-up, not an overhaul. If we wanted to have a tune-up at all, it would have been minor in nature. But instead, the government wants to control all aspects of health care. Now, let's look at Romney Care, for example, up in Massachusetts. At the time Romney Care went into effect, 2007, January 1st, 92% of the people they claim in their literature were covered. By 2010, they got another 4% covered. So why discombobulate, if you will, a system that was working so well in Massachusetts, because they have such excellent health care there, and reconstruct it to cover 4% or 5% more? It doesn't make any sense on a rational basis, and that's exactly what they did, and they were ruining the health care system that they worked so hard over a century to build up there. So we don't know the end result of what will happen with Romney Care down the road, but many people rejected it, and it's cost billions of dollars now to put into effect. Now, if you amplify that to Obamacare, that's going to be into the trillions of dollars. Where is that money going to come from? There are 21 new taxes and an incredible number of sanctions against doctors and hospitals. So when they do a sanction, they get money from the hospitals. The hospitals, too many readmissions. People left and come back in within a short time. The hospital's money is withheld, and or they're actually penalized financially in some manner. They put taxes on the insurance companies, so your insurance rates go up. They put taxes on medical devices, on pharmaceuticals, and the list is almost endless. Even houses, under certain circumstances, have gotten more taxes. Here in the states themselves, the medical exchanges failed because they were not put together correctly. The federal exchange has failed as well. That's into the billions of dollars. So money's being thrown down the drain, basically. And what do we have today? Do we have a better system today? No. We have a worse system today, because the Obamacare is offering, so-called, offering more. You're actually getting less, and that's easily proven.
Mark Davis with us today here on the big broadcast, Coast to Coast and Border to Border. He's the author of Obamacare, Dead on Arrival, A Prescription for Disaster. And He's also the author of Demons of Democracy. Let's talk about your books. How have they been doing? I know a lot of people have been picking them up and checking them out and reading them.
They're doing very well. Thank you. Thanks to people like you, we've been able to get the word out about our books, especially Obamacare Dead on Arrival, A Prescription for Disaster. And everybody should read it. If you want to raise your Obamacare IQ, you will read Obamacare Dead on Arrival, A Prescription for Disaster, because it goes through a slew of things that people need to know about Obamacare that the major media is not covering for whatever reason. They're not covering what some of the stations are bringing on, our own hack lawyers and legislators who don't know anything, literally. They just echo what the agenda is for their party, and that's not enough. People have a right to know what's going on, and my book tells them exactly where they should be. It's more than just survival. It gives you the direction what to go in, not just financial survival. It's physical survival. And if you look at the cover of the book, which was done by a great commercial artist, it has headstones, and the headstones say victims of Obamacare with a cemetery background on it. And there's a reason for that, because Obamacare will hurt people and potentially kill them as well. And we're seeing that come about as of now. There was a horrific case at Sloan Kettering, excellent cancer, still one of the best in the nation, if not the best, where a patient with metastatic breast cancer was about to go to surgery. She finds out her doctors are not anymore. They've been pushed off the health plan she was on. So they had to delay the surgery. So we're seeing delays in the surgery. We're seeing delays in treatment. We're seeing scarcities in medications, all under Obamacare. And that's very bad. And they can't prove anything else. They can say whatever they want, Obama, and it's working. It's not working, and it will not work because it's a fraud. It's a Ponzi scheme, and it should have gotten rid of it. The day they signed it, the next day they should have got rid of it. That's how bad it is.
We've got a great guest with us today. Mark Davis joins us here on the program talking about his incredible books here. Now, let's focus here. We always talk about the Obamacare Dead on Arrival, but I want to talk about this Demons of Democracy. This is a fantastic, fantastic read. Tell our audience about this.
People are going to love this book. This is a very good book in the sense it describes how lawyers and legislators are undermining every tradition, industry, and institution in the country. Not every lawyer, obviously not, but there's a subsegment of lawyers that are working against the country to pad their own pockets. And they're not improving this nation. The changes that they're putting in force actually hurt America, changing our traditions. And they affect immigration, environment, energy production. Go down the list, you'll find a lawyer somewhere in the mix. Any kind of legislation that comes out of Congress, there's a lawyer attached to it. Obamacare, end-to-end, is written by lawyers. The people knew in the Congress that the lawyers would benefit by Obamacare, and that's come to reality right now. But my book also talks about how rotten some of these legislators are. People will be interested in the sexploitation chapter describing, we all know about the Wiener incident and those kind of things. We'll multiply that by the dozens that are in this book. We talk about John Edwards and his little charades behind the scenes. We talk about, there's so many people, and going back to the Johnson time, people will not believe what their legislators have done. It's in the book. People won't believe class action suits that were actually established by government officials, and they profited by it. One lawyer who will go unnamed, as in the book, made over $1 billion. That's $1 billion on one case. And he was supported by a state attorney general. That's in the book, and it'd be very interesting if you guys read it. So Demons of Democracy has a very unique cover, again, with a man in a suit with horns, with the American flag in the background on fire. And I guess you can't guess who's on that cover. You need to look at it and see, because it's a horrific portrayal of what is happening right now. In other words, we saw ahead of time what was going to happen, thanks to the good people that helped us develop the book.
It is Mark Davis joining us today here on the program. Mark, if you want to hold the line, we'll chat a little bit more about these books. If you want to just hold a second, we're going to take another commercial time out here. When we come back, we are going to chat with Mark about his books and a little bit more about what he's got coming up. So keep it locked, keep it loaded here to the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show.
Are you out of work? Are you looking to make a lot of money on the internet from the comfort of your home? I have consistently made over $30,000 every month for the past 8 years. I have received daily $900 payments, $1,800 payments, $3,000 payments, and even $10,000 payments. It's fun, it's easy, and beginners are desperately needed right now. Sign up today at www.pcmteambuilder.com/couponjoe and make potentially $30,000 a month just like I did. Again, the website address is www.pcmteambuilder.com/couponjoe.
Dear friends, please take a moment to make a difference. They need our help. www.pathelpingpeoplefoundationinc.com. That's PATHELPING PeopleFoundationINC.com. They have to raise some money to continue their services and help to provide to those in need. $10. It may not seem like much to change someone's life today. It may not change the world, but it will help make a difference to change someone's world. Please make a pledge, friends, to help support this organization, as we so often do for other organizations, and please help. And please, friends, pass the word on to your Facebook, Twitter, Glide, YouTube, WhatsApp, Pinterest friends as well, in support of this organization. Thank you, and may God bless. That's www.pathelpingpeoplefoundationinc.com.
The response has been overwhelming, and we thank you guys for shopping the Amazon link at JiggyJaguar.com. Check it out today at JiggyJaguar.com. Recently, we spoke to another guest on our radio program, and he had this to say about Amazon.
I know you guys work with Amazon a lot. It's
yes.
The number one mouthwash on Amazon.
We're not asking you to buy anything you don't want or need. You know you're going to do your shopping at Amazon. You might as well help out the broadcast at the same time. To help out our operation, check out JiggyJaguar.com. That's JiggyJaguar.com, and thanks for supporting the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show.
What can Plexus do for you? It isn't a secret that being overweight has become a worldwide epidemic. In addition to normal concerns of clothes not fitting, lack of energy, and low self-esteem, being overweight can lead to dramatic increases in diabetes, heart disease, cancer, stroke, arthritis, and depression. Consider the following. 8 out of 10 Americans over the age of 25 are overweight. 174 million Americans are overweight or obese. Then worldwide numbers are just crazy. They're expected to double by 2030. 25.8 million children and adults in the United States have diabetes as well. If you're like millions of others, you've probably tried this diet or that pill, but you never got the results you wanted. In fact, the Centers for Disease Control reports that 95% of all diets and weight loss programs fail. Finally, there's an all-natural, healthy solution to help you lose weight, originally made for diabetics. Plexus Slim is now available. PlexusPinkDrinkHealth.com. People around the country are experiencing amazing results, and you can too. It's www.PlexusPinkDrinkHealth.com.
How many of you would like to make an extra $21,000 in the next 21 days? Call 678-318-1896. Right now for all the details. How many of you would like to receive cash daily to your doorstep? Call 678-318-1896 right now for all the details. What if you had a turnkey system that did all the sorting, sifting, and selling for you? Call 678-318-1896 right now for all the details.
Now, the Jiggy Jaguar Show on JiggyJaguar.com.
Welcome back to the big broadcast, coast to coast and boulder to boulder, all over the World Wide Web. At 46 minutes after the hour, our big interview today, of course, Mark Davis. He is joining us today to talk about his books, also to chat about his latest, of course, is Obamacare Dead on Arrival, Prescription for Disaster. He's also the author of Demons of Democracy, and he's also the author of The Millennium Diet, The Practical Guide for Weight Loss. He's a media consultant, and he's with us today. Mark, let's first of all talk about, we've been chatting about the book, Obamacare dead on arrival. We hit demons of democracy. Let's spend this segment talking about the Millennium Diet. Why did you decide to write this book, and when was this book written?
I was privileged to have a very large practice in internal medicine, which turned into a weight loss practice close to the end of the time I was practicing. And there was a need for a diet book within the structure of our thousands of patients. It wasn't originally going to go out to the public, but we put together a diet to help a lot of people who failed in other types of diets. And by trial and error, and the patients literally wrote the book, we came up with the Millennium Diet, which is a high-protein, moderate-carb, low-fat diet, approximately 12 to 1,400 calories, which had exceeded our expectations tremendously. We had people losing 30 pounds in 5 or 6 weeks. It worked very well. It doesn't work well on some people who don't follow it, but generally people who did follow it, they were losing 3 to 4 pounds a week for the first 4 or 5 weeks, and they were doing very well with it. We had people coming in very sick, couldn't go on other types of diets, and the Millennium Diet worked very well. It changes foods and food groups. It puts people in the right direction for the types of foods they should be eating. It's a very economical diet. It's not something that you have to buy prepackaged dry foods like in other programs. It doesn't make any great claims that it's going to make you lose 10 pounds a week, none of that stuff. But we have seen some patients lose a tremendous amount of weight in a very, very short period of time. It's easy to use. It's very applicable. And again, it was patient-driven. The book's only 120 pages, has a very good cover on it, people could identify it. Tens of thousands of copies were bought out there in the void. It's used on 4 continents right now. It was so popular, offshore companies took the book, scanned it, and were selling it. We saw downloads of 15 to 20,000 just from people who were selling it offshore. We never made a nickel off of that, but we were glad it's out there because it helped so many people. And it's still out there, too. People are asking me to write an update. There's not much to update about it because the diet's still working very, very well. We suggest people get it. It's really inexpensive. You can use, many times you can find a used copy on Amazon or other places. But get the book. If your library doesn't carry it, ask them to carry it. Tell them to get 20 or 30 copies in there. It's a very valuable book.
Mark Davis joins us today, 49 minutes after the hour. We want to thank you for being with us today. By the way, this Millennium Diet book, what do you think people will take away from the writing? What do you want people to take away from the writing of this great book?
On the Millennium Diet book particularly, that there is a diet out there that actually works, that's cost-effective, and you can lose a lot of weight in a short period of time without harming yourself. And that's very important. If you lose too much weight too quickly, you could harm yourself. The other thing is it reveals some of the fraud that's already in the industry, people that have great names on the TV who really don't have the message that the type of diet they're pushing could hurt people. So we're very careful how we wrote the book, and patient input was the major reason this book came to fruition, not Dr. Mark Davis. And we were very grateful for those patients to help us.
Mark Davis with us today. What makes your book different than others like it as far as diet books and things are concerned?
Diet is complete. The antiquated diets that are on the market right now cannot come up to this diet. It's up-to-date diet, and it has a different sequence of way people will eat and how many times they'll eat during the day. And it also, it's sequenced if people have medical problems. It's a big help, especially people with heart problems, cardiac, diabetes, things like that. It's a good diet to help supplement them as well. But it's basically designed for people with normal medical health. So it's a different diet because it's up to date. And those diets are based on antiquated formulas, the other diets that we will not mention here today. I wanted to just mention we have a book in the works called The Sexual Predilections of the Political Mind. People will be very interested in this book when it comes out. How smart people do not use their brains very well, and they fall from great heights because of their sexual proclivities. And you probably know some of the stories that are already out there in the press.
It is a great guest with us today. What's next for you as an author? You've got all these great books out there.
Yeah, we are working on the one I just mentioned, the Sexual Predilections of the Political Mind. We're going to do an update of Demons of Democracy. We're going to work on that as well to get that out there. There's so much new information, especially on President Obama and what he's doing now what he has done and what he's doing down the road. And we have some startling information that we won't put out. We'll put it into the book so people will see that we're not getting what we should be getting. We deserve better. Americans deserve a lot better than we're getting.
It's Mark Davis with us today here on the program. And as we wrap up with you, my friend, how can people reach out to you online?
If they want to contact me directly, very easy. Plato, PLATOMD, at gmail.com. It's PlatoMD at gmail.com. I'm president of Davis Book Reviews and Health Net's Review Services. If you have a nonfiction book you'd like reviewed, we do it. We're very economical. We get all kinds of authors contacting us for reviews. And you can't get a book out on the market today without a good review, which will help sales jump tremendously. And our website is www.healthnetsreviewservices.com. That's healthnetsreviewservices.com or platomd at gmail.com. And we're always pleasure to talk to people. We do seminars on Obamacare as well if people want small or large groups. We don't care. We just want the word to get out.
Well, good stuff, Mark. I appreciate you being with us today. We'll talk to you soon. Thanks for being on with us.
Thank you for having me, my friend.
Definitely. We'll talk soon. Mark Davis here on the program. We're taking a timeout. We've got more when we get back here on the big broadcast.
Millie and Cupcake. That's right. cowcow.com/Millie and Cupcake. Also, check out cafepress.com/Millie and Cupcake, the number one. Also, Millie and Cupcake is available on Amazon. You can purchase the book through our link at jiggyjaguar.com. Millie and Cupcake available in paperback. Also available for Kindle. It's a story of a girl and her wonderful pet. For many children, the experience of bonding with and loving a first pet is an unforgettable time in their lives. Millie and Cupcake is the charming and educational story of a girl and her companion animal, a different animal than many kids think of when choosing a pet. Check out Millie and Cupcake on Amazon right now. Millie and Cupcake also is available on the web at cowcow.com/Millie and Cupcake. Also cafepress.com/Millie and Cupcake, number one. Tell them you heard about it here on the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Show. Let me tell you about search engine optimization that is performance-based. It is SEOgame.com. Visit them online and see the difference. SEOgame puts in over 30 hours of work to start keyword phrase search engine optimization services without a setup fee. Cool? Yeah, it's very cool. If you don't like your results, you can opt out at any time before 30 days without paying a dime. At the end of 30 days, your first payment is due and you get billed monthly thereafter. 5 keyword plans begin at $200 a week. 30 keyword plans begin at $500. If you want your business to grow, you need to get SEO game performance based. SEO. Go to the website right now, SEOgame.com. That's SEOgame.com.
Techno-mall.com. Over 2 million homes are burglarized in America each year. Remove your risk of burglary with secure, remote, invisible locks. Without a lock to pick, burglars will struggle to find a way into your home or your business. You can even secure your windows and glass entryways as well. Check out techno-mall.com for more information. Techno-mall.com.
Okay, folks, let's talk about self-development, wealth creation, renewal, and rejuvenation. Are you